I'm John Weisbarth, and I travel across the country with my building partner, tiny house expert Zach Giffen. And together, we help people build their mini dream homes. In this episode of Tiny House Nation, we face our biggest challenge yet.
Little ground rules. Stay away from the moneymaker.
We're fitting a 6'10" NBA star, Matt Bonner.
There's one.
And his entire family into a 276 square foot tiny home.
You guys ready for this?
I'm ready for the magic to come in.
Tiny houses are pretty awesome. Some guys make it big and you get fancy cars.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone has a pimped out tiny house.
But having never stepped foot into a tiny house, is this family really prepared to go tiny?
Is that a storage shed? I'm gonna be a hunchback.
Zach's in trouble.
It's so tiny, it's like a dollhouse. I don't think Dad's gonna fit.
Tiny homes are the next big thing. We're in New Hampshire this week, a state known as the Switzerland of America because of these beautiful views. I'm on my way to meet Matt and Nadia Bonner and their two kids, 5-year-old Evie and 2-year-old August. Matt's a professional basketball player
and has played his entire life. He's currently the power forward and center for the San Antonio Spurs, where his three-point shot has helped his team win 2 world championships. So this isn't gonna be just any tiny home. This is gonna be a tiny home for a giant superstar and his family.
Matt and Nadia have had to move a number of times because of Matt's career. What they want is a constant home for them and the kids that can go with them wherever they end up.
I'm 35, 5 years from now. Hopefully I'm still playing for the Spurs, but you can't always control that. And this is something we can have that's consistent. Who knows where life is gonna take our family in the next 5-10 years.
Nadia loves tiny. It's her idea to go tiny.
I thought the tiny house would be a really great way to have a place that would be a constant for us because of the uncertainty of where we could be and when.
But where she's struggling is how to get her huge husband into a tiny house.
When she first brought the whole tiny house idea to me, I was super skeptical. I'm not Shaq, but I'm a pretty tall guy. I'm thinking, how am I gonna fit comfortably in a tiny house? So if we can somehow make this work and make it comfortable, I'm game.
Someone will figure this out, right? Yeah.
We've built tiny houses for tall people before, never for giants. I mean, 6'10", that's way, way taller than we've ever gone before. This, I mean, it's not gonna be easy. This is a huge challenge.
Our build site is about 45 minutes away in the nearby town of Meredith, New Hampshire. And Zach's been there the last couple of days helping the crew get a head start on the home's basic structure. They've already gotten it framed up and have installed sheathing on the home's exterior.
This is a 28-foot trailer. It's a decently sized tiny house. It's just under 300 square feet. And the plans call for a children's loft to be above the bathroom.
Is there any reason I can't fasten this guy in?
Nope.
All right.
So we need to figure out how to make the bathroom high enough for Matt, but still usable for the children.
In the off season, Matt does a lot of work with youth basketball camps and leagues, and I'm actually on my way right now to go meet him at the local Boys and Girls Club of America.
You gotta get warmed up, you gotta stretch.
What's up, Matt? How's it going, man?
Good, how are you doing?
Good, good to see you.
Good to see you too.
This is fun, right?
Yeah, one sec, guys.
Wow, so, you know, you hear 6'10"? I mean, here, let's go back to back here real quick. You really 6'10"? Yeah, you are, aren't you?
6'10" with shoes.
6'10" on paper sounds tall. 6'10" in person is ginormous. Matt is huge, and I'm not a small guy. How are we gonna make a tiny house work for a guy that's 6'10"?
That's up to you guys.
Right, yeah. I was doing a little research. I mean, you see the key? This is 15 feet, right? In the
yep.
NBA, it's 16 feet. I think this is probably only 12 feet. That's 240 square feet. This is the square footage of an average tiny house. And not just you, I mean, you and Nadia
yeah.
and the kids,
yeah.
everything.
The whole family.
You spent a lot of time in the key, I'm sure. Bet you never thought of it like that.
I know, that's a great analogy.
We definitely have our work cut out for us.
I'm excited to see what you guys do to make this work.
Well, tell you what, once you finish up here, and then when you're done, grab Naughty the kids, get back to the house, and I'll see you guys over there.
All right.
During the off season from pro basketball, the Bonner family is staying in a 2,500 square foot summer house and are building a 276 square foot tiny home of their dreams. Their tiny home will have a rugged yet modern look with clean lines and plenty of space inside. Downstairs, the home will have a cozy living room with a retro-style stove, a small but full-featured kitchen, and a master bedroom. It will also have a pro basketball player-sized bathroom, and just above that will be an open loft for the family's two kids. On a $75,000 budget, these wishes should all be within reach, but fitting a giant basketball player into this tiny house is gonna be a challenge that we've never faced before. So I'm meeting with the Bonner clan at their summer house in New Hampshire to get some details on exactly what it's gonna take to help this big family go tiny.
Hey, how's it going, man?
Good, how are you?
Good, good to see you. We going shoes off here?
Yeah, shoes off, please. I just vacuumed.
Well, I don't want to mess that up. Oh my, are these your bad boys?
Yeah, these are my basketball sneakers, so I hope they fit in the tiny house.
You're not kidding. What size are these?
These are 17s, yeah.
Well, the good news is you got a canoe if you ever need one. Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good to see you.
Welcome.
Wow, so here we are, huh?
Here we are.
That's it.
You guys ready for this?
I'm ready for the magic to come in.
I'm hoping we brought some magic.
I hope you did.
Yeah. Why are you guys wanting to go tiny? It's obviously it's gonna be tough to fit in the big guy.
Let's not get it twisted. Tiny houses are pretty awesome. Once you told me about it and I looked into it, I was like, wow. Some guys, you know, they make it big and you get fancy cars and jewelry. I don't think anyone has a pimped out tiny house, so.
I think it would be nice to have something that's a constant, something that, you know, we have roots to, we have ties to, that can come with us if needs be. And I really love the appeal of that and the tiny house movement, so I'm really excited.
You know, we look at a tiny house as something we'll be able to keep forever, hopefully.
Yeah. What is the style that you guys are looking for?
All wood, everything. We're in the mountains. We've got to be.
On the outside.
Everywhere.
No.
See, I like, you know, flannel required to walk into this house. You can chop wood at the kitchen table.
No.
Wait, so am I hearing that we have a little bit of a design challenge?
I think on the outside, we have an agreement there. I love the log cabin sort of feel, but on the inside, I like, you know, nice clean lines and granite, subway tile.
I mean, does that sound terrible to you?
I trust her.
Just
you
say yes.
You always just say yes.
Never underestimate the value of yes, dear.
Yes, dear, yes.
Is there anything specific that you have to have in this tiny house? It's gonna make it feel like a home.
My number one must have a basketball hoop with a court even.
We're not gonna have a basketball court fold down off the house, is all I'm saying.
It would be a first.
Why not? I gotta keep that jump shot.
All right, I'll talk to Zach. I'll tell Zach that's what he has to come up with.
And another thing that would be awesome would be a porch.
Our porch is really important to us. It's kind of an extension of the home. It just kind of allows you to be outside in the beauty of nature up here in New Hampshire. So porch is pretty high up on the priority list.
So this is the best room of the house.
Okay. It's not even in the house.
I don't know if you can build a porch on a tiny house, but throwing the vibe.
Is that what this is? This is one for Zach.
Zach's in trouble.
Oh, he's always in trouble.
Well, I'm getting a sense of what Matt and Nadia would like in their tiny home. Back at the build, the windows are going in and spray foam insulation is being applied. And Zach is meeting with the contractor, Nick, to get the exact measurements for the kids' sleeping loft.
Oh man, I love to see this pretty spray foam. Yeah. They did a really good job.
They did.
All right, do you know what our full roof height is now?
I think it's 11.4 to the top of the ridge.
Okay, so 11.4, how's that?
So right here.
So our actual space, probably at what, 3'3.5"?
3'3.5".
So that's not really that big, but that's just the kids.
That's just the kids. At least now the framing's tall enough for him to walk into the bathroom.
When I'm building a house on a trailer, I'm normally installing doors that are fitting into a 6'8" rough opening. But for Matt, he'd still be hitting his head on that.
Who would have ever thought that you had to build a door 7'1.5" on a tiny house? Where's the 4x4s?
far as sentimental items? What are the must-haves?
This is one of my favorite pictures of the kids, so that would be awesome
for
me.
Okay.
This was made by my great-grandmother. It might fall apart, it's really old.
Yeah, I'm seeing that.
So it has a lot of sentimental value.
Okay, that's really cool. Now, what about the kids? Do they have any special requests? Our challenge with this tiny house isn't just a 6'10 basketball player, it's also a family of four. There's the kids, and you have to consider what they want as well. Hi, I'm John.
Hi, John.
What's your name?
Evie.
Evie, very nice to meet you. And who are you?
August.
Oh, that's kind of cool. So there's a magnetic.
Yes.
Have you heard about the tiny house yet?
It sounds really cool.
It does? It sounds really cool?
Really cool.
Nice. What are you hoping is in the tiny house?
Like, it's close to a beach and nature and stuff like that.
I like that. That's the beauty of putting a tiny house on wheels, is you can put it wherever you want. What are some of your favorite toys?
A big ball.
Are you a basketball player like Dad?
Yes. I like snuggly toys or baby dolls.
Cool, and you seem to like building blocks, too.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I'm really excited about the tiny house.
I do have one more surprise for you guys. I mean, you're like, oh, tiny houses are cool, I'm super into it, but you've never been in one,
no,
right?
Never.
Well, we're gonna change all that. Oh, look, it's coming down the... I called it a favor, and this is from Tiny House Northeast.
Is that a storage shed?
No, that's tiny living, big man.
Wow.
So that's a tiny house.
Wow.
What do you think? Wow.
That's tiny.
This is the reality of what you guys are talking about.
Wow.
So that's a tiny house.
What do you think?
It's tiny.
It's definitely tiny, yes.
Yeah. This is the reality of what you guys are talking about.
It's so tiny, it's like a dollhouse. Does it have an upstairs?
It does have an upstairs.
Can we go inside?
Yeah, let's go inside.
This thing's not gonna tip over or collapse, is it?
No, it's not.
Okay. No, it's pretty sturdy. Huh.
August, look at these!
Sold.
Oh, there's toys.
Yep, you got stuffed animals.
Everything is so cool. So cool.
It's very, very tiny.
8.5 feet wide is as wide as you can go.
Okay.
By 13.5 feet.
On in. Well, boom. This is what I was worried about. You only have one chance to make a first impression, and my first impression was, wow, I'm gonna be hitting my head on this on a daily basis. I'm gonna be, for sure, be a hunchback.
Well, this is probably 6'4", right? Okay. This is kind of like the highest that we go.
This is the highest you go, come on.
I mean, typically, this is not going exactly how I thought it was gonna go. How are you in there?
Same ceiling height.
One look at Matt and Nadia, and I feel like this is not going so well. Oh, well, that's all right, I found that light. I hope it's not backfiring on me.
I'm not as optimistic as when we had started.
It's pretty suffocating.
Yeah.
And it must have comes with a chiropractor. I don't know how it's gonna work in the long term. It's drastic.
Yeah, I don't think we had mentally prepared ourselves for this.
I mean, it's hot out today.
I'm
probably
sweating.
See us sweating.
Yeah.
It'd be nice to have some air conditioning.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sweating because this is going so poorly. I didn't.
The kids love it, but this would not work for me. I thought it was gonna be awesome, but honestly, how can we possibly fit in that?
As quaint as this is, I don't think it would work at all.
Yeah.
Listen, this is a typical tiny house. Nothing has been customized for someone that's 6'10", and I don't know exactly how we're gonna make it work, but we're gonna make it work.
Okay.
I just gotta get them out of this house before they just blow the whole project up. Come on, kids.
I don't wanna go. I like this house. I want it to be ours.
I mean, on the bright side, kids love it. Seeing Matt in that tiny space was a wake-up call. I'm meeting up with Zach to make sure that when the Bonners see their own tiny house, they get a better idea of how we plan to customize the space around Matt's huge frame. Hey, how you doing?
Oh, I'm doing great.
Good, you setting up?
Yeah.
Well, I just came from the Bonner residence. Brought that tiny house over for them to check out, and I'm afraid it may have backfired. He couldn't fit under the loft, he couldn't get under the door, and it just has me stressing a little bit on making sure that we make this house fit. And I know that's always been on our radar, but I don't know, reassure me.
You're gonna like what we've done.
Okay.
Okay, because we already elevated the loft, so I gave it another like 6 inches.
Okay, okay, good. The one thing I do wanna touch on, we're talking a lot about Matt, and obviously he's literally the biggest concern we have in the house. I don't wanna forget about the kids. Yeah. August and Evie, August is into the balls and loves basketball. Evie, she's got her dolls, she's got these like building blocks that she's making dollhouses out of, and we can't forget about that.
Okay.
There are two more quick things, though. Matt really wants some sort of a deck or a porch or something. And he keeps mentioning having, like, a basketball court. I see you shaking your head already. Obviously, it can't be a full basketball court, but I just want to put that on your radar right now.
Okay, how about this? How we find a basketball court, and then we park it at the basketball court.
Perfect. Done. I'm sold. We just got to sell him on it now, okay?
It's day 3 of the build, and the crew is installing drainage pipes for the shower inside while beautiful cedar panels are going up on the home's exterior. And it couldn't have happened at a better time, because I'm bringing Matt and Nadia to the build site to get a first look at their new tiny home.
How are you guys feeling about the process so far, a couple of days in?
And I'm gonna level with you, John.
Yeah.
After seeing that house, I think I've lost a little bit of confidence.
My little experiment in tiny at the Bonner house didn't go so well.
It's pretty suffocating.
Yeah.
I don't know how it's gonna work.
So I'm a little anxious now, more so than usual, as I'm bringing them to see their tiny house. We are customizing the house so that you can fit in it better. It's about time to see your tiny house for the first time.
Wow.
You see it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Soak it in, guys.
Gorgeous.
Right?
I love it.
Wow. Love the roof line.
Isn't that cool? Isn't that really
super
cool?
Super cool, yeah, and the windows as well.
So nervous right now? I love it.
So let's go talk to Zach here. What's up, buddy?
Hey.
Hi. Nadia, nice to meet
Matt.
You.
Hi, Matt. Nice to meet you.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
Awesome.
We're pretty happy with things, how things have been going.
Awesome.
Compared with the other one, 20-foot trailer, this is a 28-foot trailer. Are you feeling a little less anxious looking at it from this point?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
It's amazing how much of a difference that 8 feet in length makes.
Exactly.
That siding, wicked awesome.
Well, that is beautiful cedar. There's almost hardly any knots in that cedar.
Yeah.
It's not easy to get wood that's that nice.
I love the exterior, but speaking of exterior, I think we mentioned a porch, if possible.
I mean, I'm totally with you.
Yeah.
The porches, I think every house deserves one.
Yeah.
We need to put some thought into what we can do that would be clever, because it's got to be transportable, right?
And that's always the issue with these things. Like, if it's just going to sit somewhere forever, then you just build a deck around it. But to have the deck be able to travel with it is what makes it a little more of a challenge. Let's get inside. I want you to see the space and you know, see what it feels
like. Let's have a look-see.
And remember, it's obviously an unfinished space at this point. Oh, man. Is that doorway too short?
A little bit. A little bit.
So Matt has to duck to get into his house? Not a good way to start the tour. I might strangle Zach.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Is that doorway too short?
A little bit. A little bit.
I can't even believe it. I was so focused on Matt's height and making it work in the interior that I completely forgot about the front door.
Honestly, I'm used to ducking under doorways.
No, this is your house.
Yeah.
You don't duck under your own front door.
So the door is something that obviously we want to change that. But other than the doorway, I mean, the space feels bigger, right?
It does, and is that a loft?
It is, and underneath is the bathroom.
Come on,
let's check it out.
There's a loft.
I'm praying that I didn't forget anything else, because if I did, I'm never gonna hear the end of this from John.
Here we go.
Hey. Ow, what that way? Hey. Come here. Dude, there's plenty of room.
Yeah, there's clearance there. High five.
That works?
Yeah. Can you fit under that?
I think so.
Let's see.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, that'll work, right?
What I am kind of worried about is the bedroom. It's a constricted space, and you'll see what I'm talking about.
My bedroom.
See, still plenty of height there.
Yep. Wow, look at the ceiling and everything, though.
Ceiling's awesome. It's nice to have the high ceilings flow throughout the main space of the house.
Yes, no matter how much headroom we have, because it's obviously nice, it's the constriction in the floor space that we're dealing
with. It's a little tight.
Yeah, I mean, obviously the bed's gonna dominate this space. You can head there, feet here.
Be curious to see lengthwise how this will work.
I mean,
it's tight.
It's tight.
I don't see how Matt is gonna be comfortable in a standard queen-size bed. So I wanna brainstorm any ideas that I can come up with to make this a better fit for him overall.
Do you guys feel like a little bit of that apprehension from the first tour melted away a bit?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, this feels better, right?
For sure.
Yeah.
Okay, then in that case, let's let Zach start figuring out some of these problems, get out here, and we'll get out of his way.
Thanks, Zach.
All right, you guys are so
welcome. We'll see you soon.
Well, that tiny house visit went much better than the first, which is a relief, and Zach tells me he's already started to work on the plans for the porch Matt and Nadia have asked for.
I still have some things to work out inside the tiny house, but before I can do that, I have to design a nice porch the family is gonna love.
My idea for the porch is very simple. It's just gonna be a platform that lives underneath the trailer and slides out. It's got adjustable legs.
Normally, a simple porch like this would be easy, but on a tiny house, it's gotta be strong, light, as well as portable. That's where it can get tricky.
The main problem I have whenever I'm building a deck that's gonna be portable is weight. It's just a lot of wood. So when I'm building this deck, material is gonna be paramount, and making sure it's a material that's as lightweight as possible, yet rigid enough to hold people's weight, isn't easy. One material I do know that is gonna do that for us is aluminum. Now, I don't weld aluminum,
but there's a dock builder nearby who is an expert at it.
I don't know if he's receptive to work with us, but if so, I think that that's my best option.
Hey, you must be Terry. So, my name's Zach.
Nice to meet you, Zach.
A friend of mine, Nick, sent me over to talk to you. He said that you might be able to help me.
What do you need?
I'm looking for a deck.
I'm a dock builder by trade. I can weld aluminum, but I won't have time to do a deck on a house or anything like that, so.
This might be harder than I had originally thought it would be.
Okay, well, let me just explain. It's a deck on a tiny house, and the deck is also tiny.
I never do this, but desperate times call for desperate measures, and I'm gonna have to name drop.
Okay, we're building the tiny house for a local professional basketball player.
I can only think of one from now around here.
Big redheaded guy?
Yeah.
That's Matt Bonner, right?
Yeah.
I've seen him play, he's pretty good.
Okay.
I'm very busy this time of year, but I really like Matt Bonner. I think he's a great player, so why not?
Really?
Yeah, I'll work with you.
We just got really lucky. I guess he's a fan.
How big is it?
I think about 6 foot of length.
Yeah.
And then I measured out 5'9", but it's meant to actually slide underneath a house that's on wheels.
That's not really very big. I mean, I could probably do that tonight.
That would be super helpful. Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
This retractable porch is gonna add a whole new element to the Bonner's new tiny home. Here are some other ways furniture can retract and expand in amazing ways. Everyone has cabinets in their kitchen, but with the right design, you can have the whole kitchen inside your cabinets. If you start to nod off during a movie in this chair, no problem. It expands to form a comfy bed. With this cleverly designed dining nook, you'll never have to choose between storage and seating. You can have both. Back at the build, the crew is cutting and installing real local stones to form a heat shield behind the wood-burning stove in the living room.
Hey, that looks really good.
Yeah.
We actually do so much stonework for tiny houses, and never once has it been real stone.
It just makes me so satisfied to see somebody actually doing, like, real stone masonry.
By cutting the stones down in half before we mount them against the wall, we're actually getting that quality of the real stone with half the weight. So it's the best of both worlds.
And it's locally sourced stone.
I think for Matt, like, this is really gonna tie it back to his home state. To be from New Hampshire, have stone from New Hampshire, I think that that's definitely gonna make it work.
Okay.
While the crew continues mounting the stonework behind the stove and laying in the subway tile that Nadia loves in the bathroom shower, Matt and Nadia have asked me to meet them at their storage unit, where apparently they have some things packed away that they think would be a good fit for their tiny home. I'm usually a glasses half full kind of guy, so I'm hoping that the storage unit is half empty.
All right, which one is she?
Number 59.
Oh, well, yeah.
Our things.
The glass is overflowing. The only way to do this is just to jump in. If we see something that you guys want in the tiny house, let's just pull it out. And then we can kind of make some decisions before we start loading up.
We've been saving a lot of stuff in storage that we hope will make it into the tiny house. I'm super confident that a lot of the things I wanted in there will fit. That would be nice.
Okay, so let's get in here.
I don't know if this would work, but this is actually a queen-size mattress. How about these chairs? They should fit. There's a wood piece over here that I thought might be cool.
This?
Yes, that was actually my great-grandmother's.
My autographed El Guapo bat. Oh, yeah.
Why do you guys have this?
We do work out sometimes.
They're pulling out boxes of dresses, rugs, ginormous shoes.
We definitely have to have these in the tiny house.
I mean, if they keep this up, we're gonna have to change the name of the show to Tiny House Hoarders.
I mean, the more stuff we can get out of here into the tiny house, the better in my book.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, time for a reality check. I mean, they went from thinking that their tiny house was too small to thinking they just have unlimited room. Not all of this is going to the tiny house, I'm sorry. We need to take another look at this. Because I think about maybe 10% of what you pulled out will actually fit in your tiny house.
So 90% of the pare down now has to go.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm, here's the reality of it, right? I mean, this is, for sake of argument, about the size of the tiny house. So your living area is basically right in here.
Not a lot of room.
Not a lot of room.
What about the rugs? Oh, yeah, that's...
I mean, listen, we don't have a hallway to fit this rug. So what we need to do is we need to take another look at this. I think an easy one, we have to have the bed.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, let's just focus on the smaller sentimental items.
Matt got me this last year for my birthday. It's not small, but it's awesome.
So if you want that, absolutely.
My team photo.
I think that's a good one.
Our first date.
I love it. Now, this is what I'm talking about. Let me take some of this stuff, start loading up, I'll help you. This feels okay.
I feel good about our selections.
It's day 4 of the build, and the crew is installing beetle kill wood panels to the inside of the home, which will give the rustic cabin look that Matt loves while still maintaining the clean, modern lines that Nadia asked for. While they do that, Zach and I are about to get to work on some surprise items for the kids, and we've enlisted Matt and Nadia to come and help us out.
Just the people I was hoping to see.
We want this house to work for you so that you're not bumping into things, right? And that's been a lot of our focus, but it's also got to work for the kids. So Zach's got some ideas, and we figured, why not bring you guys in, A, see what you think, and then B, see if you guys want to help out.
So I want to make a dollhouse for Evie where the thing fits together kind of like the magnetic blocks she loves to play with. And then for August, I'll make a mini basketball hoop that can go into the loft.
The backboard folds down and now it's just a shelf.
Multifunction.
If one of you guys wants to use the jigsaw.
Oh.
Have a volunteer.
I made a spectacular birdhouse in shop class in high school.
Good, all right, they're working.
Like a toy basketball is probably like this size. That'll work.
Sweet. Have you ever used a jigsaw?
I'm gonna go with a hard no on that one, Zach.
Okay.
It was awesome. Nice. I was really pleased with myself.
That was perfect.
And impressed with Matt's skills.
All the way through. Oh, and keep going. All right. Good.
It's really cool to do something special for them to make it unique and personal. And they're gonna love playing with that hoop in the dollhouse.
Good.
Look what I did, honey.
I'll tell you what, whenever this professional basketball thing's done, come on the road with us.
All right.
Two more cuts and we're done. Much better cut. Dude, look at this, man. It's day 5 of the build and the crew is installing the electrical and roofing. While they charge ahead on the house, Zach and I are gonna take a charge or two on the basketball court where we're about to go up against Matt. Look, an opportunity like this, it doesn't come around every day. So yeah, I'm gonna take advantage of it. I mean, no one ever said building tiny houses couldn't be fun too. There's no way we can do a full basketball court, but we do wanna try and do something. So we'd play you for it.
Basketball?
I mean, as a professional basketball player, obviously it's not gonna be a one-on-one game, but I think 2-on-1, first to 5, you beat us, then we'll figure something out.
So that's a bet.
Really?
Yes.
Do I think I can beat Matt Bonner in a 1-on-1 basketball game? No! You can't guard 2 people at once. Count it.
I'm a tool guy. I gotta go get my tools.
What do you got in the bag?
I got everything.
Check him out. He's already intimidated.
I gotta warm up.
High knees, John. High knees.
Little ground rules.
Okay.
Stay away from the moneymaker. Make it, take it.
Yes.
First five by ones?
Sure.
Great. All right, let's go for it.
I'll toss it up.
All right.
Just so you know, this is street ball. No blood, no foul. Ready, set? There it is!
Oh, that's it.
Oh, no. He's driving.
There's one.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Rebound, Zach!
I almost had that one.
All right, check it up. Two.
Okay. Hello, sports fans. Let's take a look at that play one more time. Giffen going strong on the baseline. Oh, he's rejected by Bonner. That's going to leave a mark.
What is that? That's prison rules? Isn't that what you called?
Let's be honest. We need help. Hold on. Time out. I'm calling in some extra guns.
One of the ground rules I forgot to tell you about is we can sub up.
Sure. Brenton,
director, come on. You're in.
Put that down. 3v1. Can't guard three people at once, right?
Oh, in.
John.
Got to get him.
Oh. Okay. Hold on.
It's game point.
Yeah, I know. We need one more. Okay. Camera down.
There you go.
Okay, I'm confident you cannot guard four people at once, right?
There's four of us. I'll loop back around. Yeah. You fake the pass here, look from underneath. Yeah. Go.
Okay?
Yeah, he's listening to our strategy.
You guys are ready?
Yeah, here we go. Football player, huh? Got it.
I just want to let you guys know this is going to end on a slam dunk.
Here we go. Let's go back and see that one more time. Sorry, Zach.
Good game.
Nice plan.
Now, I fully expect a basketball hoop on that tiny house somehow.
It's day six of the build, and the appliances have been delivered for the custom cabinets that will house all of the home's kitchen utilities.
You can believe it, we're gonna fit every single one of these appliances within this cabinet box.
So this is the entire kitchen?
I mean, yeah, it's the Appliances of America. They make these really tight little micro kitchens. So it's gonna be a sink, two burner cooktop, dishwasher in a drawer, and then also a refrigerator.
You got it all in 9 square feet.
Yeah.
While they work on those cabinets and install the home's AC unit, I'm checking in with Zach to see how he's healing up from that beating he took on the basketball court yesterday.
What's up, man? Yeah, I thought I'd bring this by. See a little more practice in. You were supposed to be my professional athlete. You were my ace in the hole for this game.
No, I never played basketball.
I know. That was pretty fun, though, wasn't it?
It was so much fun. Nice. Good break from the day. I'm going to admit something to you. I was going to put a basketball hoop on the house anyways.
Do you have something in mind?
You know, you just build a mount, attach it to the house. When the house gets to where it's going, then, you know, just take a ladder, put it up there, attach some bolts, done.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's fair enough.
The one thing that I actually did want to show you that's done, ta-da, we have the porch.
This is the porch. Huh.
I found a dock builder to custom build this aluminum frame.
Okay.
And check it out. I mean, for being like a substantial stiff piece, like that is pretty lightweight. But
yeah.
I think for this, it's going to work perfectly. The deck boards are going to run perpendicular to the slats.
Mm-hmm.
And then this side is actually the one that's going to slide underneath the house.
Oh.
And it's going to be clipped down. And then when you get to where you want to go,
you'll slide it out like this?
Yeah, yeah. So it stows away for travel.
Got it.
And then you can slide it out. And then over here, you know, these holes are actually meant for the leg supports.
Gotcha.
I think it's going to give them what they want. You know, they asked for a porch.
Yeah.
This is a porch.
I think they'll like it.
Yeah.
I really do.
I'm going to actually start getting in on this cedar and start attaching them down.
All right, good. And when you're done with that, the only other thing is I want you to, you know, work on your basketball. All right, man, I think it looks good.
That one, that was my one and only basketball game of the year.
Downsizing your living space and going tiny, like the Bonner family, doesn't mean you have to downsize your love of the game. Don't have a court to play some pickup ball outside? You can make a game of it inside with this basketball chair. Turn your regular game night into a full casino experience just by moving a few panels on this transforming table. This ping pong table doorway can give you privacy when it's closed, or you can rotate it forward and challenge your family to a tournament. Back at the build, Zach and Nick are moving ahead, adding some reclaimed antique barn wood that will act as a railing around the kids' loft.
This came from a barn from the 1700s.
Construction was a different thing back then.
All right.
Just let me know if I can help.
Okay.
Hey!
Hey,
how's it going, Zach?
Nadia?
How are you? Nice
Good.
To see you. I had to drop by the site because I heard a rumor that you lost a basketball game yesterday.
I mean, you're not surprised, right?
I'm a little surprised. I heard it was 5-on-1 or something like that. I don't know. I heard that Matt won a full-size hoop. Where is this going?
Well, I have a good solution for it. Check out the basketball hoop I got. So it's a full-size basketball hoop.
That's a full-size hoop,
and
Zach.
I'm going to get it at the actual regulation height. So I found a spot on the back side where there's no windows.
Okay.
Put it on there, and then we don't drive with it there, but it's like just get a ladder, and you can just kind of easy off, easy on, and then you just got a basketball hoop on your house.
Okay. I know it's really important to Matt, so if it has to be there, is there a way to hide it somehow or mask it? I don't want it to be an eyesore.
My original plan was to make the basketball hoop simply bolt onto the house, but after talking with Nadia, it sounds like it's gonna take a lot more engineering than that. Okay, I'll see what I can do.
Yeah. Thanks, Zach. We'll see you.
Bye, Nadia.
Bye.
It's day 7 of the build, and we're past the halfway point in building our new tiny home for our tallest homeowner yet, pro basketball player Matt Bonner and his family of four. The home's main structure is set and appliances are in, but the devil's in the details. The crew is building some storage space into a custom headboard for Matt and Nadia's bed, and Zach is doing one final walkthrough to make sure Matt will fit inside the home.
I like the like that high-waisted belt. You're fashionista now? What is this?
This is actually a highly functioning piece of equipment.
Oh, I get it. Yeah, it's keep the gut in. That's nice. Yeah, it's good. Listen, I get it. You're getting older. I understand.
No, it's not about the gut. I do need to do something about that.
Okay.
No, this is totally different.
Okay.
Check this out.
What?
So this is all about measurement. So I want you to measure up.
What
and I
is
need to
this?
See. This is a strike indicator. For a head strike indicator. I'm trying to see exactly how much headroom that Matt's gonna have.
You are so ridiculous. And the only thing that's funnier about this than how it looks is that it's actually a pretty good idea.
So,
I can't believe it. Okay, so what are we doing? We're gonna measure it out?
Yeah, you gotta measure. Obviously, you know, here's my height.
Let's see, yeah, actually, let's get a little creative.
6 foot, totally, you know, reasonable, highly attractive, Zach's height.
By the way, buddy, I don't know how to tell you this.
I know, I'm 5'11".
Yeah, not quite 6 feet. All right, so this is your height, precious.
Okay, John's height is gonna be 6'3", 6'4", right?
Let's call.
Well, that's darn near monstrous. Just write that down.
6'4", that's right here. We'll call that striking.
And then,
6'9", 6'10", with shoes on.
Okay, just mark it at 6'10".
Okay, so this is, excuse me, how my armpits? It's a good thing I'm doing this. This is called gargantuan. It's just the most ridiculous thing ever. All right.
Okay, you ready for this?
Yeah, let's go.
All right. Pretend I'm Matt.
Okay, hey Matt.
I'm going to the kitchen. I gotta check out something over here. Oh!
No problem.
Look at that. No issues, huh? All right, good. We're clear over here. Check the bedroom. I mean, obviously the bedroom is the issue.
Yeah.
Queen size bed. And I had an idea that I think is gonna make this room way more comfortable for Matt. What I'm thinking is like a footboard to make this bed extend
so his feet don't hang off of it.
Yeah. I think it pulls out, and then I think it flips up. It's already got a mattress attached, and then it slips back into place
when he's not using it.
Can you design it or have enough room to flip it out and do all that stuff?
How close am I?
To Matt, that's like 10 inches.
So, I mean, I think that's a great way to go. I like that it maintains our space around the bed, which is crucial, but it also makes it comfortable for him, which is also crucial. So if we can knock those both out, then I love it.
These custom touches are going to make tiny living much more satisfying for Matt. Now, we're headed to Monte Rio, California, to get some inspiration from another tiny home that uses its vaulted ceilings and rustic charm to ensure that even the tallest guests are comfortable. Nestled in the peaceful woods, this tiny home matches its surroundings perfectly. With an exterior made of weathered wood shingles and simple wraparound deck, any flannel-wearing nature lover would fall in love at first sight. With an outdoor shower, hammock, and barbecue, some outdoorsmen might think they already have everything they need, but the inside is where this home shows its true colors. The home holds on to its cabin-based roots with exposed wood paneling and a wood-burning stove, but living here isn't exactly roughing it. The cathedral ceilings and large windows give the home an airy feel with plenty of natural light. A spiral staircase leads up to a bedroom loft perched above. Marble countertops and modern fixtures bring the style, convenience, and comfort of city life to the forest, leaving the neighbors and traffic behind. Like the Bonners' future tiny home, this beautiful property looks tough and rugged on the outside, but inside, it's all about the luxury. Now, I'm headed to crash the Bonners' midday lunch party to see if they'll be able to handle these family gatherings when the rest of the house, including their porch space, gets much, much smaller.
Hey, guys.
Hi. Hey.
How's it going, guys?
Good.
Hey, John.
So this is what you guys were talking about originally with the porch.
We are out here a lot.
I have some news. We were able to figure out a way to get you guys a porch.
I'm sensing a butt.
It's obviously can't be this big. What we're able to do is give you something that's roughly 6 feet by 6 feet. Would you guys indulge me in a little experiment so we can kind of see exactly what 6 feet by 6 feet feels like?
Yeah.
Actually, if everyone could stand up, we kind of like huddle into this corner. I brought a tape measure.
Boy.
Okay, so we're basically, if we're going from the post, I mean, this is 6 feet right here.
So our dinner parties are going to be very close.
Actually, you got to move in this way a little bit more.
Oh, you didn't make it into the party, Pop.
Here's what we have, you guys. Basically, we have this post to roughly that post.
You got to make sure the table's in here.
Yeah, okay, we're just going to not have a chair, I guess.
There's a
this
chair.
This didn't make it.
This needs to come out, too, I think.
Let's put these little guys in.
There.
Just bring the food table to you guys. All right,
we're
hold
spilling.
On.
All right,
if you do that, how am I getting out?
This is good. I wanted to make sure we guys had some food,
good.
So
okay.
This is your space. Go ahead and have your party. Let's just do what okay. You would do here. I mean, if you can, I'll...
Could you pass the napkin, dear?
I can't move.
I'm going to body surf over to
like
the fruit section.
A dinner party in an elevator.
Yeah.
Matt, you're the host. Let's get some food here.
He's probably the only one who's got the reach.
Yeah, there you go.
Where should I put this?
Ow! Stepped on my foot.
It's a little claustrophobic to kind of be cramped in there with all of those people.
I guess you got to kind of pare down your guests, too.
Watch that elbow, Matt.
There we go. Just call me Lazy Susan. I'm not stopping. You got to reach quick.
Yeah, okay, all right. I do understand this feels weird and ridiculous, and it is a little bit, but the point that I want to try and drive home is that it's about changing the mentality. That's the biggest struggle for people when they go tiny. It's like sports. How much of sports is a mental game?
A lot.
Right?
You have to readjust your thinking, change how you look at things.
Yeah. You know, Zach and I will deliver a house to you guys that's going to be beautiful, but then you have to live in it, and that will feel a little awkward at first, and you'll have to work through that. But that's what I want you guys to take away, that it is a mindset change.
Right. I'm still kind of happy we're getting the porch, so.
Yeah, exactly. And that's exactly the attitude. Enough of ruin your party. Let's everyone spread back out and have some fun, all right?
Woo!
All right, here we go. Get this over here.
Watch that. Let's go ahead and we can set it down here.
Yep.
Oh, man. That really came in the nick of time, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, long wait for those.
The real project is the deck, right. And I still haven't even welded the brackets underneath.
All right. Good luck.
Now that the doors have arrived, the crew can finally get them installed and finish putting up the siding on the exterior, which is great because we don't have a ton of time. While the crew works on that, Zach has to figure out how to accommodate Nadia's request to hide the basketball hoop when it's not in use.
We want to give Matt a functional basketball hoop that is regulation height, but we can't just have it hanging off the side of the house and have it be an eyesore. So I have an idea to make the basketball hoop hide away in a cabinet that matches the siding of the exterior of the house when it's not in use. So when it's time to shoot some hoops, the cabinet doors will open up and the basketball hoop extends out, click, 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 all the way up to 10 feet. And the beauty of it is that the kids, if they want to play when it's a little bit lower, now they can. And when you're done, you just crank it down into the cabinet, close the doors, hide it away, and you're all set.
Now that the hideaway hoop issue has been resolved, Zach can focus on finishing his other big task, Matt and Nadia's screened-in porch.
The aluminum cedar panel needs to fit into the brackets that I welded underneath the trailer so it can easily slide in and out. And then all I gotta do is finalize the framework for the screen. This is like gonna be a support for the porch.
Got it. Okay.
And this is actually gonna have like a mounting plate on it,
All right.
Like this. This one's for the bottom, this one's up top. That mounts to the wall, and then this can kind of tuck away, so when you drive, it's just all flat against it.
Okay.
And then when you park, now you just take the handle, open it up, and then this gets connected down to our deck, and then when we actually put the bug netting around, then it becomes a porch.
I like it.
Yeah, a tiny porch.
I mean, I've already told Matt and Nadia that we're giving this thing to them tomorrow. How far away are you from having that buffed out?
I mean, it's gonna be a real late night for me no matter what.
The crew is working into the night, laying down the pergo flooring that will put the final touch on the cabin in the woods design that the Bonners want. And Zach's attaching his custom screen frame to the porch. It's day 8 of the build, and the Bonner tiny home is really starting to come together. The porch is now done, and Zach is finishing the installation of Matt's hideaway regulation hoop, while inside, the bed frame with storage is going in. It's almost time to get this beauty on the road and show it to the family. There's just one problem.
We don't have a driver. The driver backed out.
The driver for this?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
you can drive it, right?
I mean, you're tripping your tiny house all over the country.
I definitely can drive it, but I don't have a truck that can pull a house anywhere close to that big.
How heavy do you think this is?
We're 10,000 pounds. If we can find a truck, I'm game. Let's do it.
While Zach is out finding a truck that can pull this tiny home, I'm helping the crew pack up and get everything locked down and ready to hit the road so that we can move this house to Concord.
What is this?
Surprise, surprise.
Dude, nice work.
Yeah, Nick's friend came through. He's a stonemason.
Dude.
This is perfect for us.
Awesome. This way, this way. Keep going. It looks good. Brakes are on. Dude, you got it.
I told you I've done this before.
Ready for this?
Fast rolls.
Hey! I mean, that's the beauty of tiny house. People tend to get out of your way.
Are we gonna play some music or just do our own? On the road with a tiny house in tow. Got my best friend John. Ding ba ding to down, and he finally let me drive.
Enjoy it.
This is it. This is here, right here. Pull up.
Over here?
Yeah, right where that fence is.
You're thinking that we can just kind of weasel in between there?
Well,
I mean, it's really tight.
Okay, watch this.
Let's bring this in that way. Yeah, really crank it. Probably about it. I think it's a good spot. I think we can clear a little bit of this out. That's kind of perfect.
We've got enough room for the deck to come out.
I think this is good. I think we drop it and we get going. We've already been behind schedule.
I want to deliver this, and I think it works where it is.
With the home in place, we've got some final touches to make before we show the Bonner family their brand new tiny home. A ceiling fan is going in to help keep everyone cool and comfortable. Countertops are getting locked into place, and a ladder to the kids' loft is being installed. On the outside, we're adding the final piece to the slide-out porch, a full screen that lets the view in but keeps bugs out. Just over a week ago, we arrived in New Hampshire to help pro basketball player Matt Bonner and his family build the tiny home of their dreams. Matt and Nadia's kids loved the idea of going tiny from the start, but fitting a 6'10" giant into a 400 square foot tiny home without major comfort issues was unlike anything Zach and I had done before. We showed the family that they didn't need many possessions to create a constant home that the kids would love, no matter where Matt's career might take the family next. Zach was able to create a space that fit both Nadia's modern visual design and Matt's rustic charm, and made sure to include some playful additions for the home's most important residents, the kids. We also added a full-size basketball hoop for Matt to keep his skills sharp and a screened-in porch for the family to spend time on together. Now that's proof that big things can fit in small packages.
Whoa.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
Awesome.
It's beautiful.
Look, Bella.
That is cool.
That's a baby house. That's a baby house. That's a big house.
The tiny, tiny house.
The tiny, tiny house.
The roof comes up and you can look inside.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Your dad actually helped build your dollhouse.
That could be a fairy house.
It could be a fairy house.
First impression.
It's beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
What we were going for was sort of the quintessential New England cabin feel on the outside, right? We wanted to make sure that we delivered that.
So excited to go inside.
There is still another thing I want to show you on the outside.
Okay.
Yes.
I noticed that.
Right? I see this.
So the real challenge was, how do we make it portable?
Yeah, where does this go?
Let's show them.
All right, John.
Okay.
I'll stand here and spot.
Okay, all right. So basically, just pull it off the top. There's just stakes in the ground.
It's staked into the ground like a tent.
Exactly. Yeah. This thing rolls up very nicely.
These pieces come apart. Now, these are little handles. They just rotate over. Now, boom. After that, these just pull up. John, pull it out. And then, really, it just slides in.
Oh, my gosh. That's perfect.
That's awesome.
Now you're ready to roll down the road.
This is good. This is awesome.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, yes. I'm glad that you love it so much.
Can I go inside?
Yeah, you've literally seen nothing yet. So check out your new tiny house.
Awesome.
All right. Excited. Tiny house.
Nice. Well, we're going to stay out here and let you guys check it out on your own.
Yeah? Exactly. All
right. You guys check it out for a minute.
Thank you.
Watch your brother. Oh, my God.
Wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Hey. I fit. Nice. Awesome.
Oh my gosh,
look at the wood.
Awesome. It's
walls and ceiling. Look at that, it's like a little fireplace.
It is a tiny fireplace.
That's so cool.
I love the woodwork. And the chair. Just gonna make myself comfy here. Watch a show. Perfect, we can travel with Daddy to all his games now. We'll just attach this to the team bus.
Absolutely.
Is that a dishwasher? Is that a tiny dishwasher?
It's a tiny dishwasher.
It's a tiny dishwasher. Look at that fancy sink, Evie. We don't even have a sink that nice at home.
I'm taller than you now, Dad.
You are, aren't you?
Oh my gosh, you gotta look at this chair. I could sit up here and read to my dolls for hours. Good.
This is really cool. Better than I could have imagined.
Mom, I already found the shower.
And look, Daddy. It's awesome. Oh my word, Evie, look at this bathroom.
You guys.
Isn't it beautiful?
It's beautiful.
I love it.
Look at the door.
Focus.
Peek-a-boo.
On the subway tile, that's amazing.
I'll give you that.
It's a very pretty bathroom.
I hear some good sounds coming from in here.
This is amazing.
It's like so much to take in. It's all awesome. Wow.
Do you guys like this better than the first tiny house you saw?
Yes.
This is unreal.
I mean, I know it wasn't built for you guys, but this place.
It didn't feel at all like home. This feels like a home.
Yeah, it doesn't feel super claustrophobic or anything.
Right, and that's because, you know, we can only go 13 and a half feet
tall, right? And we used every inch of that inside wherever we could. I mean, the loft space, very minimal in here so that we could keep it feeling big. So you didn't have to do the hunch over thing.
And to have the loft as a three-quarter loft instead of a full all the way across, I mean, what that does is it makes Matt feel comfortable in this place because you don't have to go through this kind of low overpass to get to your room.
The ceiling height is like really important to me, so nailed it.
You talked about wanting to have sort of the rustic modern. It was all about the finishes that we use in here.
Super fun being here in New Hampshire because the access to materials, you know, just the local stone that we were able to use for the hearth.
Love the stonework. Those are beautiful.
The loft was a challenge for us.
I was a little bit worried that it was gonna be too short because we had to give your dad so much headroom in the bathroom. What is that?
A hoop.
It's a hoop.
So you want to know who built this basketball hoop for you?
Mommy built that with her own two hands.
Mama!
Yeah!
You're so smart, buddy.
It's not that it just is a basketball hoop, because look, if you go like this, and then you actually release that, now it pulls down, and now it's a shelf.
Can I have it?
I think he likes the basketball hoop better.
Okay. Just say. He is definitely your child, Matt. Yeah. He is on this basketball thing, and he's pretty darn good, too.
Ah, that's the needle point. And you put a beautiful frame around it.
Yeah.
Did you see this? This was my present from Daddy from last year.
Picture from our first date.
Oh. I love it. And look at this bedroom.
Wow.
So cool.
I mean, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. I love the light fixturing. This is a queen?
This is a queen.
This is the one from storage?
Yep. This is the one that from your storage, but Zach made an upgrade that I'm pretty sure you guys are gonna like.
So here's the thing is that I wanted to make this room super comfortable for you. So we have a little footboard.
Whoa.
I wanted to make this room super comfortable for you. So we have a little footboard that actually turns into an extension. John, you wanna undo the release over here?
Right here.
It slides out and then just folds down. Slides back. And there you go. Now you got a spot to put your feet at night.
Yes. That's genius. You should patent that. Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Wow. The feet don't hang off.
What is that?
That's awesome.
Yes.
I love the bedroom. The little footboard extension so I can fit lengthwise was amazing.
That's the first time I have ever, ever seen him fit on a bed. Ever.
I don't know if you saw these columns right here. This is where all your nightstand stuff would go.
Aw, I love it.
Do I have one too?
Yeah, you got one.
Awesome.
Perfect. Cool.
You can hide things from the children.
Yeah, exactly.
Our chocolate stash.
Yeah, there you go. Now, the only bad news is that you gotta put your shoes back on, because we got more to show you, so. Oh,
yeah. All right. We had the wager for a real basketball hoop full size, and I beat their butts on the court. They better be giving me a basketball hoop.
This is a present that actually was supposed to be for your dad, but in actuality, I think it's for everybody.
Wow.
Look at that.
This is a basketball hoop that is meant for everybody. Because here it goes.
Wow. That is so cool.
Look, it's getting higher and higher.
All the way to daddy height.
It goes all the way to 10 feet?
Oh, yeah.
That's unreal.
Or you can leave it low for the kids.
Adjustable too?
Yeah, exactly.
It's meant for August and you because it goes low. It's meant for your mom because it goes away and it hides. And she doesn't have to look at it.
It's kind of nice to have an outside element that involves the kids and an activity. So I'm actually really pleased with the way it turned out.
And then really it's for your dad because we lost a basketball game and we had to do it.
And they came through in the clutch. It's really cool how it's adjustable so it can grow with the kids as they get bigger. It's gonna be a lot of fun shooting hoops as a family. Shoot it!
Boom!
Nice.
Yeah!
This was, not to sound too corny, but our tallest task ever, right? Having to design a tiny house that fit a guy that's 6'10". You know, I think it turned out really well, and I hope that you guys think
it's so beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Beyond my wildest dreams. It's incredible how you incorporated everything we asked for. Great job.
I love my tiny house. I love it. I think it's
It feels very us.
There is one last thing we have to do, and that is officially welcome the Bonner family to the tiny house community. You guys got a tiny house.
Tiny house.
Oh, God.
All right.
I was definitely skeptical, but the tiny house movement is tall guy compatible.
Oh, yeah. I like it.
Thank you.
Nice. Matt, Nadia, and the kids have been using their tiny house for 2 months now. How have they handled going from tall to tiny so far? We're headed to New Hampshire to find out.
Meow, I like this. What'd the kids say?
Meow.
I'm really happy with the way it turned out. It just feels very warm and very inviting and spacious for being so tiny.
It's nice out today, huh?
Beautiful.
With the porch, we wanted something that matched the cabin-y, mountain-y feel of the exterior of the house, so we redid that.
It's a little more cumbersome and difficult to put away, but it can still be folded down for transport.
I bet the leaves are gonna start changing color soon. It'd be so nice to be out here.
Yeah. The porch is kind of like a private sanctuary, so you just kind of relax and listen to the sounds of nature and just unwind.
Yeah, as soon as we have time, it'd be so good to get like a little table out here.
We gotta figure out the table dining situation. That's a big thing.
A few other little tweaks that we've done to the house is we added a couple little throw pillows, you know, one from Matt's home state of New Hampshire, one from my hometown of Toronto, and a couple pieces of artwork. But I think the biggest and most significant change is the door in the bedroom. Having privacy and a little bit of separation from the kids is key.
And I love the extension at the foot of the bed. You know, it took some adjusting. I'm used to my feet hanging off, and now they don't.
I think my favorite would be, I think it's the bathroom. That's a nice bathroom.
I don't hit my head in there, which is great.
Yeah.
I don't have to worry about ducking or hunching. It's awesome.
August.
My favorite part of the tiny house is the loft. I like seeing the kids' faces up there. They're just smiling the whole time. It's really fun for them.
Do it again.
Somewhere new and exciting, and it's small, and it's adventurous, and they love it.
Hey, don't climb up there, August.
Well, there's a few things after actually being in the space that needed a little bit of adjusting. Our son is a sneaky little one, and so the loft railings needed some adjusting in terms of the spacing and the height, so we kind of fixed that to be a little more August-proof.
We'll shoot some hoops. We've shot around on the adjustable outdoor hoop a couple times, and it's really cool and everything. The kids love it.
Let me know when.
Stop!
But we still have to figure out how to kid-proof the mechanism that raises it up and down before we let them shoot around on their own.
Nice shot.
So that's one thing down the road I think we'll try to figure out.
Score!
And I think it's just been a blessing for all of us and a really positive experience, and we're very thankful.
Nice study. Way to train them young.
The thing I'm most excited for with the tiny house is being able to spend more time with Nadia and the kids.
August, what's your favorite part of the tiny house?
The basketball.
Who knows where life is gonna take our family. Where do you want to take the house?
Texas.
Yeah. I think we've been blessed with a beautiful tiny house, and you know, who knows what adventures we'll have, where we'll take it.
I'm John Weisbarth, and I travel across the country with my building partner, tiny house expert Zach Giffen. And together, we help people build their mini dream homes. On this episode of Tiny House Nation, Zach and I help a competitive triathlete couple that believes going tiny will help them go the distance.
How come there's so many bikes?
You have the bikes that you ride in the rain, and
you have a backup bike just in case something happens to your bike.
But training for tiny in their very first home will test their limits in brand new ways.
We don't want it to look like a gym.
No, this is something we're not willing to compromise on.
Can Zach channel his unique creativity and minimize this couple's living space?
All of their training supplies,
It
all fits into a coffee table.
Wow.
Without sacrificing their big plans for the future.
What do you guys think? House that keeps on giving.
Tiny homes are the next big thing.
This week, we find ourselves in Northern California, just a little ways outside of Santa Cruz, right on the coast. And it is gorgeous here. I mean, redwood trees, cliffs, the ocean, they've got it all. Right now, I'm on my way to meet Tommy and Katie, a couple that truly enjoys competition. And I'm not saying that because they're in direct league softball. They're world-class triathletes. In fact, Katie is an Olympian who's still on the U.S. national team.
I went to the Olympics this past year in 2016 in Rio.
The Olympic experience is an amazing and really neat competition.
These two met overseas while they were competing.
In 2013, I went to the World Cup in Tisjavars, Hungary, and met Katie.
Do you want eggs?
Heck yeah.
We just had a really good connection, a really strong connection.
And then a couple days after a year anniversary, I asked her to marry me. Been good ever since.
Tommy and Katie travel so much competing all over the world that when they're home, they don't have a place of their own. They just crash on friends and family's couches. They've decided it's time to finally put down some roots of their own, and they want to do it tiny.
So it was definitely my idea in the first place to go tiny. I never thinking in my wildest dreams that he would be like, okay.
Since we're traveling 9 months out of the year, we don't want to spend a bunch of money on a big giant house that we're not living in. But being able to come back to a place that is actually ours and that we've helped design, like, that's going to be amazing.
We've never had our own home. That makes me the most excited.
Zach is 2 hours away at the build site in Martinez, California, with our general contractor, Hunter, from Total Property Solutions, going over the plans for our latest tiny home.
Just wanted to talk to you about the layout. So, I mean, you got the front door, and then really it gets right into the kitchen. It's refrigerator, then you got the range, looks like a little bit of countertop. Moving back, I mean, you got the bathroom, and then it looks like they got a big living space.
And then there's a loft above that.
But then it's got this kind of angled pitch on the design. That's like a spot where you put some chairs and you got a little outdoor space that's covered.
Well.
While the crew continues framing out the home, I'm on my way to Tommy's parents' house about 90 miles away in Santa Cruz, where Tommy and Katie are temporarily staying.
Hey.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good. Welcome.
Tommy, huh?
Yeah, nice to meet you, John.
Doing a little work on the bikes,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, just finishing up setting my new race bike up for this season, so.
This is cool.
These are all bike-specific tools.
Can I tell you what I don't like?
What don't you like?
How many bikes there are here. Is it just me, or are Tommy and Katie storing enough bikes for the entire Olympic team? Hope they're charging rent.
Hi, I'm Katie.
Hi.
I'm a hugger.
Good, I'm John.
How come there's so many bikes?
You have the bikes that you ride in the rain, you have the bikes that you ride for draft legal racing.
You have a backup bike just in case something happens to your bike when you're racing.
You can only ride one at a time, but.
Those are obviously expensive pieces of equipment. I mean, how much upkeep and how safe do you have to keep them?
Yeah, well, like right now, even how we have them isn't really ideal. We need to make sure they're more secure than this.
All of this stuff out here is all.
All of our stuff. Since we travel all the time, we had stuff in Maryland at her parents' house. We had stuff at my sister's house.
Seeing all of our stuff actually in one location, we actually have a lot more than I think we initially thought we did.
Basically, this whole porch, which is the size roughly of their tiny house, is filled with triathlete gear.
Trail shoes, racing flats, all around shoes.
It has me nervous.
I guess I just didn't really think about the and the triathlete.
Swim, bike, run, so you gotta get gear for all three sports.
We haven't even gotten inside the house yet.
That's true.
Can we see what's going on inside as well?
Sure.
Back at the build, the crew is applying weatherproofing wrap to the home's exterior, while inside, they've started installing the home's insulation.
Hey.
And Zach is dropping off a special delivery that will help keep the inside nice and warm.
We're almost done insulating. As soon as that gets done, we can start doing the floors.
Well, this is the radiant floor heating.
Oh, wow.
It's super cool product, especially for athletes. They've been swimming, they've been out in the cold, and they come back and their whole house is nice and toasty warm. And it's not like it's just coming from one spot, it's coming from everywhere.
I want that in my own house.
While the crew begins laying down the radiant floor heating, I'm making progress of my own, working with Tommy and Katie to find out what they'll need to cross the finish line in our race to go tiny.
So this is where we're currently living.
Like right here.
Literally right here.
Yeah. How big is your parents' house?
Roughly around 1,000 square feet. And then we're gonna be downsizing to 370 square feet.
Well, you guys are already living tiny.
Yeah. So we basically travel 9 months out of the year outside of the country. She is doing really well. She's ranked fourth in the world right now, went to the Olympics, has won the highest level races you can.
This is my
time to brag about her, but when we come back, my parents are nice enough to let us crash here, and that's one of the biggest reasons why we're going tiny, is we want to come back from all the travel, all the training, all the racing, and then have a home.
Yeah, I mean, I get that. This is probably a little bit less than ideal.
So when you're training 25, 30 hours a week, you're just dead tired.
I mean, 25, 30 hours a week? It literally is your job.
Yeah. We don't do anything else. And when people ask us, like, what are you doing in your downtime? It's like, sleep, eat.
It sounds like you need the tiny home to be a little bit of a sanctuary.
Yeah, we really just want to make it an escape from triathlon. So yeah. Relax and just feel good about it.
Okay, well, what's important in here? I mean, like, I imagine these might be somewhat important.
Yeah. It does have my first WTS win in Hamburg, which is the biggest win I've ever had.
What's WTS?
World Triathlon Series.
Okay. What else?
We have a painting that my uncle actually did. That's our engagement.
Oh, that's cool. Well, let's talk, actually, kitchen. Obviously, this isn't your kitchen. How big of a deal is the kitchen for you guys?
It's very big, because it's the first thing we do when you wake up, and it's the first thing you do when you get back from working out.
Yeah, and, like, I'm a really big fan of making smoothies, so, like, I use my Vitamix over there, and it's quick and easy.
We'd rather have more kitchen space and less dining room space.
Well, let's talk about what the house is going to look like.
Beachy, cool, like, kind of a summer vacation home.
Just kind of have that coastal vibe and the openness. We want to have somewhere comfy, cozy, and really, like, warm. That would be another one.
Warm. Okay, let me get back and talk with Zach and just kind of see what he's thinking.
Okay, yep.
Thank you, guys.
All right, cool. Okay. Thanks.
Good, thanks a lot.
Tommy and Katie are temporarily staying in Tommy's parents' 1,000-square-foot big house while Zach and I get to work building them the 370-square-foot tiny home of their dreams. This athletic and adventurous couple needs a home that reflects their personalities, so the exterior will feature a sleek modern form with earthy and rugged wood paneling. Inside, the home opens up to a large living room with enough space for a comfortable couch and even a large coffee table. A roomy bathroom will feature upscale fixtures and a large full bathtub, perfect for a soak to help them relax after going through a rigorous training schedule. When it's time to refuel after a grueling triathlon, the couple will make use of a large kitchen complete with a breakfast bar, tons of cabinet space, full-size appliances, and a small storage loft above. At the end of the day, they'll head upstairs to the roomy master bedroom loft with plenty of space for a large bed surrounded by windows and skylights that will make the room feel even larger. On a budget of $57,000, Zach and I will give this pro athlete couple a pro-level tiny home that maximizes every bit of productive space and leaves the extra weight behind. Back at the build, the crew is quickening the pace, installing double-paneled vinyl windows and adding gorgeous curb-mounted skylights over the bedroom loft to let in more light. I'm swinging by to check in with Zach and give him an update on what I've learned from our couple.
Check this out. Boom. So there's a couple of Katie's medals, and I know you know she's an Olympian. I mean, an Olympian in Rio, and hopefully an Olympian again in 2020 in Japan.
Wow, World Triathlon?
Yeah.
Is that a gold medal?
Yeah, first place.
Dang.
Yeah. Well, it's the really cool thing about this. It's also like our biggest headache because there's so much stuff that is all the triathlon stuff.
I thought triathlon stuff was supposed to be small.
Well, that's what I thought.
Like,
but it's
bathing suits and running shorts and stuff.
Yeah, well, shoe after shoe after shoe, 8 bikes.
It's gear. That's going to be the priority of their house. It's going to be a challenge like always, but I think the only bad part about it is that I know they're going to make me feel really out of shape.
It's day two of the build, and the crew has kicked up the tempo as they begin adding tongue and groove siding with contrasting colors to give the exterior a unique look.
Are we gonna have it horizontal on the exterior, or is it gonna go vertical?
It's gonna go all sorts of different directions.
Sweet.
And up above, shingles are being applied to the roof. With that done, I'm bringing these two world-class athletes to get a first peek at their new tiny home.
Here we go.
Let's jump out, check it out.
That looks awesome.
Hey, Zach. Hey, come on out here. Katie,
hey, guys.
Tommy. Hey. This is Katie.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Tommy.
In the house.
Yeah.
I know. We're so excited. It's bigger than
I
thought.
Yeah, it's bigger.
Okay. Like, taller.
Well, it's kind of a unique shape.
Yeah.
It looks very aerodynamic.
It actually looks fast.
Yeah.
Which is not what I normally say about a tiny house at all. Nice. This is a racing tiny house.
Do you guys want to see the inside?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Let's get in there.
Come on in. The first thing that you'll notice is that it's still a little bit wet inside.
Yeah.
You know, and that's just because when we were framing, it's been a total monsoon.
Yeah. Yeah.
When I first walked in, I was kind of thinking like, whoa, this is not as big as I thought.
It feels big on the outside. When you come inside.
Yeah, yeah.
A little bit more compact.
Yeah.
And I like the skylight. That's sweet. And then the stairs that'll be here.
Yep.
Well, let's walk them through the rest of the space so we can kind of explain where everything is. So kitchen is here, right?
Yeah, it's gonna be storage pantry, washer and dryer, sink centered by the window, a little piece of cabinet. Over here is gonna be the range.
Yeah.
And then this storage loft up above the kitchen for long-term storage. But the one thing it's not gonna store is bicycles.
Yeah, yeah.
And well, yeah, especially because there's like 8 of them and we're gonna work on that separately.
We've actually addressed bicycle storage a number of times. And what I've really done is kind of utilize the headspace within the vaulted ceiling.
Are you planning on storing the bikes in the house?
I mean, that was kind of where I was thinking.
We can't really do that.
We do not want the bikes in the house for sure. We do not want the bikes in the house.
They're gonna be going outdoors and they'll be pretty dirty. We'd much rather store them outside, but still keep them protected from the weather.
I guess in my mind, I was thinking like, being a triathlete, so much fun that maybe you would have a different idea, but.
You can come train with us every day.
It's not as fun as it sounds.
It sounds like so much fun. Like, well, run until you're about to puke, and then you swim until you think you're gonna drown. And then just ride your bike really far.
Okay, maybe I'll just stick to carpentry.
Not inside means we have to find something outside.
Correct,
ideally.
But we still want it like covered and safe and locked.
I'm just hoping that they figure something out to make sure that they're also easily accessible.
That's good information that Zach's gonna have to figure out. Just my favorite thing.
Because we have all our bike tools that we need to work on our bikes and like bike stands to like clean it and stuff.
Just keep in mind, in a tiny house, like it is kind of all about compromise.
This is something we're not willing to compromise on.
And I get that. We'll figure this out.
Hold on. We are gonna figure this out, as in we.
Yes, as in we. As in we're a team. As in when the team wins, we both win. I know you got this.
Yeah, all right. We may need to rethink this arrangement. Maybe I can show you the bathroom. No compromises in the bathroom.
I love it. I kind of want to get in it. But.
No, you can't get in it yet. There's too much construction.
There's more to show you.
Okay, but come on in here, actually.
So this is the living room space. The couch would be back here, it can actually fold out into a bed.
Cool.
Awesome.
That's awesome. Yeah. And then we'll have space to train inside too, right? Set up stationary bikes inside.
I thought we just decided the bikes were outside. And now you're saying bikes. I'm actually very confused.
If it's dumping rain, you need a dry space to actually get your workouts in. And that's where bike trainers come in.
Did they just ask for the bikes to be stored outside?
Yeah, I mean, it makes perfect sense to me because they don't want them inside, they need them outside. Except for when they don't want them outside, they need them inside.
Yep, still lost.
So you set your bike up on the trainer and it's nice to ride, you can watch TV.
We also have to do our core routines and strength routine. It'd be really nice if we could actually do some of those exercises here. But to have a stand where we can put things like computer, phone, remote.
Snacks.
Maybe a towel. Water bottles.
But we don't want it to look like a gym. That's the part that's...
No, we want to be able to put everything away and have our nice living room.
We know it's a lot to ask for, to have a living room, to have a place to work out, and also a guest room. It really is important to us.
All right.
Oh,
well,
gosh.
We should probably get back to work.
Let's give Zach and his team the space to figure all that out. The three of us will take off, okay?
All right, nice to meet you guys.
It's day 3 of the build, and the crew is in a great rhythm, putting up wood paneling on the walls and on the ceilings inside, and moving forward on a staircase to the bedroom loft. And Zach is tapping into his well of creativity, putting pen to paper and coming up with a way to store the couple's large road bikes without taking up all of their valuable interior space.
So Tommy and Katie, their whole life revolves around them doing triathlons. And so having a space where they can store their really expensive bicycles is totally paramount. This home's shape has a beautiful angle on one side, and that gives me a cool opportunity.
My idea is to take advantage of the space underneath by building out the inside of that cavity and make it into a storage space to keep the couple's bikes accessible, but also keep them safe and secure. Half of that cavity is gonna have a deck that folds down. The other half will be a shed roof that folds up, so they won't have to worry about the rain, and they have a nice place where they can actually stand to do the work.
Well, that's the problem, right? Anything back here when you're going down the highway. John.
What's up, man?
What is this?
It's a unicorn, Zach. What do you mean, what is this?
Is this all the bikes that they have?
I pared them down to just one bike. I'm amazing. No, I actually haven't pared them down at all yet. I brought this because this is one of their road bikes. Check this thing out.
All right.
Pick that up. You thought I'd gone to the gym.
It's like one finger bicycle.
All right, don't show off anymore, gosh. No, I brought this vibe so that you could solve some of our problems.
I was just actually up here, because the space is triangular, it's not like a shed. How are we gonna really make it secure? What I'm really talking about is enclosing this entire space. When the bikes are in there, they're completely locked in.
Yeah.
Like, you don't even see them, you don't even know that it's there. It, you know, more or less has a wall. Part of it comes down and turns into a deck, and then the other part lifts up and acts as like a shed roof. And then the bikes just lift it up, hook it on something, and then it kind of cams over to the side.
Okay, I like that.
And that way, hopefully, we can fit three bikes, though. I think that's where you come in, John. You gotta back me up on this one. I know they're Olympians. I'm not trying to, like, you know, mess with their livelihood.
All right, so you're saying three?
I know I can fit three in there.
All right.
Can I hold on to the bicycle?
I will leave this with you under one circumstance.
What?
This is not a dirt bike.
I don't need
you going all Zach Giffen tabletop weird jumps, okay?
All right.
In fact, here, I'll go put this somewhere safe. You get back there and figure out where it's gonna live forever, okay?
All right.
I'm gonna put it in the truck.
I'll be easy on it if I ride it. How about that?
No riding it.
I'm not gonna ride it.
You don't get to ride it. God.
Now that he has a plan, Zach and the crew have started bringing his thoughts to life, creating custom bike storage for our racers, and their crew is fabricating a metal frame for the fold-down deck and shed roof that will go into an alcove on the side of the home. As they work on that, I'm meeting up with Tommy and Katie to help them pare down their belongings and prepare for a journey to the top of the tiny home podium.
My little podium. Perfect. So you know what today is?
Pare down day.
Today is pare down day. Where do you guys think your trouble area is gonna be?
Definitely the bikes.
I agree.
For me, it's gonna be hard. I have some things from the Olympics and sentimental value.
Yeah, that almost falls into sentimental.
Yeah.
Paring down is tough. It absolutely is. So I figured let's do something that you guys are familiar with. And if you see here, I've got my little medal stand kind of set up. Here's your gold, silver, bronze.
Nice.
It's the podium.
Yes, it's the
this
podium.
This is getting real.
We're gonna do a new Olympic sport. And I'll be the national paring down team coach, okay? So what we're gonna do is this. Gold will go for the item that's gonna be the toughest for you guys, and that's gonna be the bikes. I'm gonna keep you guys to two, maybe three bikes.
From eight.
Yeah, for me. I'm gonna keep you guys to two, maybe three bikes.
From eight.
Yeah, for me. That's what the goal is, okay?
For me, it's gonna be hard to pare down bikes, though, because my bikes are my babies.
This will be for, like, clothes, pots and pans. This will be for sentimental stuff. You guys are gonna have 10 minutes, okay?
Yep.
Let's do it.
Well, your time starts right now.
All right.
Okay. Well, I think we should start with the bikes. So there's my road bike.
Two time trial bikes.
I'll get the helmet.
And I definitely need a road bike.
Oh gosh. Four bikes. I was hoping for two, maybe three. You can put it over there for now.
Okay, I'm taking all my shoes.
All of your shoes?
Yeah. Okay, I can get rid of boots and slippers and stuff like that. I'd rather keep my training shoes.
Probably get rid of some hats.
So just so you guys know, you have less than 6 minutes. I don't see any clothes.
Okay,
I don't see any sentimental stuff. There's no pots, there's no pans. Oh, we're putting more shoes in there. Okay.
I found the pump.
Whoa, nice shot.
Thank you.
4 minutes, guys. You got 4 minutes.
Got to the close.
Bike tools, feedback sports trainer. Super important. We rode this in Rio at the Olympics.
Here's the opening ceremonies jacket.
This is the Olympic blazer.
Yeah.
Wow.
I think the Olympic stuff is just the scariest thing to pare down.
So this is the watch you got.
That's probably the most difficult part, is kind of deciding just what's most important. Is it the sentimental items or is it what we need to do for work?
I think about when we have kids and I want to be like, look, I was cool. I went to the Olympics. I still want to be able to show them something.
Right now, I mean, the Olympic experience is so fresh in my mind. However, as I get older, I might want to bring something out to show someone. So kind of making those decisions of what's going to hold the most importance over time is really hard for me.
Listen, this is not about giving up things that are meaningful. You know, a home without sentimental items isn't a home at all. The way to think about it is which few of these can I make?
Okay, but I'm keeping the watch. I'm sure I'm keeping this. Having our first home to put different sentimental items that all have memories, that's really nice to relive every now and again.
We're like seconds away. Five, four, three. Oh yeah, more shoes. Two, one. Okay, done. Stop!
What is that?
Okay, all right. How do we feel?
I feel overwhelmed, so.
Okay.
I don't even think I brought pants.
That might be a problem. Bikes.
We're gonna have to figure out how to fit two time trial bikes and two road bikes.
I will go to Zach, but we can only do what we have space for. It might have to be inside.
Yeah, we're gonna keep them.
Right, yeah. There's a lot more here than I thought. Big thing of tools.
It's full of bike tools, but we don't have regular tools.
I mean, are you anticipating needing lots of tools other than your bike tools?
Well, yeah, when we need to do something in the house or measure something or drill, like, we need to borrow from other people.
So what you're telling me is that you're gonna need space for some general handyman tools that you plan on getting?
Yeah, non-bike related tools.
Okay, duly noted. Now, we are done here, but it's not official until you break the tape. All right, here we go.
Oh, I think you won.
Oh, photo finish. You guys are on the Olympic team. Great job. Olympic Committee 2020? Call me. I think we got a new event.
It's day four of the build, and the crew has got their heart rates up, laying down flooring throughout the living space, while in the bathroom, unique wood-like gray tiles are being applied on the floor and inside the shower. And outside, the AC condenser unit is going in. While they work on that, Zach is back in the lab working on a plan to turn this one room into a one-stop shop for relaxing, bike training indoors, using their laptops, and having snacks. And the key to all of this will be a custom transforming coffee table that can tie things together perfectly.
Katie and Tommy are top-level athletes, and they do not take breaks just because it's raining. They want to be able to exercise and train indoors when the weather is bad using a bike trainer. But their living room can't just be a training area. It also has to be a comfortable living room. So their equipment has to be out of sight when they're not using it. I'm working on a way to give them exactly what they need to stay in peak form, rain or shine, by designing a custom coffee table trainer. And I've asked John to come over and take a look at how it will work. Okay, so this is a bike trainer. But I actually have a way cooler way to pull this off.
Well, okay, what are you thinking? Talk to me here.
The entire unit fits into a coffee table.
Wait, say that again.
Coffee table flips up, it exposes your stand, and then the coffee table actually folds open into a desk area where they can put their laptops, their phones, TV remote.
You son of a gun.
Come here, let me show you what I'm talking about. This is an electric generator. And when you pedal, it turns this little motor and puts power in this battery pack. And it's gonna be like a really cool way that they can actually take their exercise and turn it into something useful for their home.
Are you kidding me?
This is definitely gonna keep their phones, their computers charged solely by pedal power.
I mean, so I love it. You got me a generator and you've got me a way to make their training room also a super comfortable living room because it all just goes away under the coffee table, which would be there anyway.
Yes, yes.
You've outdone yourself, my friend.
Zach's bike training table looks like it's gonna be perfect. Here are some other items you can use to make better use of pedal power. You won't need to choose between working and working out with this industrial style desk. Get riding and your laptop's battery will last as long as you do. And it doesn't stop with electronics. You can attach this kitchen grinder to the top and use pedal power to make fresh oatmeal in the morning. This leg-powered cart takes fresh coffee on the go to a whole new level. Just crank away and you can cruise to a new location and power a grinder for a fresh batch of brew. With the right choices, you can get in shape and get a bigger return on your workouts than ever before.
That's incredible.
God, okay, man. I love it, buddy.
It's day five of the build, and as Zach works on assembling the pieces for his custom transforming coffee table, the crew is installing modern white kitchen cabinets. While that happens, I'm planning a mission of my own to Home Depot.
In-store layout, tools and hardware, aisle nine, done.
The home improvement toolkit I'm putting together will definitely come in handy for Tommy and Katie as first-time homeowners.
Hi, welcome to the Home Depot. How may I help you?
Well, I'm looking for tools, so hopefully you can help with that.
Absolutely.
We're building a tiny house, actually, for Triathlete. And we have a little workshop area that's for their bikes, but also we're looking for tools so they can do little projects around the house. They're homeowners now. They don't have any tools of their own. They've expressed a need for that.
We have this Ryobi system.
Yeah.
It'll power 70 different types of tools and accessories.
All with like the same battery pack?
Yes.
Okay.
I would recommend the combo kit, which comes with two batteries and a charger. 18 volts, all cordless. Then you can add on any amount of tools and build your collection that way.
Let's do that. This is a light, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, halogen light.
Made some bits, maybe?
Impact driving bits.
Yep, awesome, okay. Here, you take this.
Okay.
I'll take the heavy ones. Oh, they're not even that heavy. Nice, thank you, man.
All right.
Back at the build, the crew has found its stride, painting the home's exterior in earthy gray and brown, while inside, the custom ordered kitchen counter is going in, and Zach is installing the frame and laying down planks for the home's fold down bicycle storage. While they work on that, I'm heading to meet our athletic couple to introduce them to a whole new kind of training that should get them prepared for what it will really be like to work out indoors in a tiny space when it's too nasty to go outside.
Your living room is 10 feet deep and then 8 feet wide. We know there's a couch in here. Keep this about here. So I want to see you guys work out. Is it doable?
I guess we'll have to find out.
Yeah, we'll see. It's pretty small.
It's extremely small. Much smaller than our normal workout space.
Am I going to get kicked?
Ready? Left first.
I'm hitting the bike trainer, so I'm going to have to work on that.
Okay. This is definitely not like any other workout we've ever done together.
Lunge, and then turn.
I'm not even doing the
and
right legs.
And then you have to alternate legs, though. Hey, this isn't working.
Sorry, I gotta go lower though.
That's fine. Yeah, working out in such a tiny space with two people is, starting to get hazardous.
Oh, here's my table. That's fine.
There you go.
That's great. Oh, I'm sorry. Never seen exercising like this. I'm not an Olympian though, I guess. Well, okay. What's your assessment of how this worked?
Well, I don't think we would be doing this.
Didn't that work very well?
The lesson here was more about you might not be able to be in here and do the training like you guys normally do it.
We're probably gonna have to compromise a little bit and might have to go to separate parts of the house or figure something else out.
For us to do it separately to make sure that we get in the good core routine, like, yeah, we could do that.
The nice thing about a tiny house is that you can be in the kitchen and she can be, and you're still only like a few feet from each other. You know what? Let's clean up this area.
I'll take the couch.
And I won't do anything.
All right, well, come on.
It's day six of the build, and the crew has started their final sprint towards the finish line, hanging folding doors for Zach's bike storage zone and installing shelves for the tools and equipment inside. While that happens, appliances in the kitchen and lighting fixtures are going in. Now, it's time to get this home on the road and moved into position
right there
to a piece of land in Santa Cruz, about 10 minutes away from where the couple have been temporarily staying, so we can get it ready and hand over the keys to its new owners.
Good work on the jack, John.
All right. Are you guys ready?
Ready, set.
Now, hey, Zach, don't let him turn until we're clear.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay, so it's right up here is where we're going. Yep.
Okay, just on the side of the driveway?
Yep.
Keep coming.
All right, whoop.
Yeah, all right.
Woo!
Now that the home is in place, we have a few last minute things to do before we finally bring in Tommy and Katie. Hanging some final pictures, adding Tommy's skateboard, and I'm jumping in to get the home smoothie ready with a new blender, while Zach puts the final touches on its outdoor bike tuning station and stocks it with the brand new tools. While we do that, the crew is getting the composting toilet into place, and we're just about ready to cross the finish line.
You're a pro athlete building for another pro athlete. You tell me, how do you think we do with the house?
I love this house. With triathletes, they just give it everything they got, and I tried to channel some of that kind of attitude into the build. Hopefully the house reflects that.
Living tiny is hard enough, but training in that tiny space, I mean, that's uncharted territory for us, but I love what you did with the coffee table bike trainer.
Living room.
Living room, yes.
Because, yeah, I mean, first, it's gotta be their place to relax, but then it has to transfer into their training facility. And really, the pedal power generator pack, in my mind, that's just the cherry on top.
Does it get the Zach Giffen seal of approval?
Stamped.
I had no idea how much gear came with training for top-level triathlons, but once these guys got going, honestly, they did really well.
I mean, honestly, if anyone can appreciate trimming down on the things that slow you down, it's a professional racer.
I mean, exactly, that's a great point. But the stuff they did want to keep, they didn't want to see. So we had to get creative there as well, and the bike tuning storage zone that you came up with.
Yeah.
I mean, stroke of genius.
Storage, but safety and security.
I think the house is gonna be a perfect fit for them. I
can't wait to see the size of those smiles.
It's really exciting to, like, actually have a home.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna have you put your heads down. It's a long road. I want you to just see it all at once. All right, heads up, guys.
Oh!
Let's jump out, let's check it out.
Oh my gosh.
What do you think?
Oh my gosh.
It looks like a home. It's beautiful.
Wow, this is beyond what I was imagining.
Does it look like what you thought your home would look like?
It looks better. Yeah,
really?
It does.
Yeah, for sure.
My face is like shaking with excitement.
Does it still look like a racing tiny house?
It does.
I still want to race all the other tiny houses. We would definitely beat Zach in a tiny house race. Our house is much faster than his house.
Very arrow.
You guys feel like seeing the inside of the house, or?
Very much so.
Yeah.
Get in there then, go for it.
Oh man, this is so awesome. It already feels like home.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
Oh my goodness. Like just the plants and the decorations, it makes it homey.
Holy moly.
I love the cabinet.
I feel you shaking, you're so excited. The kitchen, the fridge, the cabinets, everything's incredible. Wow.
Tommy, did you see the storage up there?
Like, awesome.
That's awesome. That's
out of the
perfect
way.
Place, yeah.
Didn't feel small at all. Like, it just felt like a great space. Every part of it fit together exactly how we wanted it to.
Oh, wow.
Oh my gosh.
It's so nice. And it just feels like the driftwood feel.
Very beachy, like, and yeah, calming. Oh, look at our painting. That's really cool.
Look at that beautiful table, Tommy.
I know, this is gorgeous.
Look at this couch. It's a real couch.
And with the photos and everything, like, you could tell, like, oh, this is gonna be our home. Like, it didn't feel like somebody else's home that we were gonna stay in, which is what we've been doing in the past. It really felt like our place, like, this is ours.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Come on,
we're enjoying our comfy couch.
Man, what do you guys think?
Oh, it's so awesome.
Does it feel homey?
Yeah.
Very much so.
It's perfect.
It definitely feels like a fully functioning kitchen.
Do you see this kitchen working for your lifestyle and what you need out of it?
For sure, yeah. This is even better.
Can we show you some more?
Oh, yeah.
Please do.
Okay.
I want to know what you think about the bedroom.
Oh, my gosh. There's so much more room up here, actually.
There's so much space.
The loft is, oh, man, it's so amazing that nothing can beat that. There's just so much space up there.
How's it feel?
Ah, really good. Oh my gosh. The mattress is amazing. There's skylights up there. I can just keep going. Like, it's just so awesome.
Does this feel like the bedroom that you guys were envisioning?
It's perfect, especially like to recharge and things like that. It's just calming. It really even smells nice.
That's Zach. I do my best.
I guess you gotta stay.
This is incredible for recharging. Like, this is the most comfortable mattress I think I've sat on.
This mattress is a Bear mattress, and this is specifically for athletes. It has this cooling property too that helps you recover and is super comfortable, good for your back.
This is even better than we imagined.
Well, we've got more to show you.
For being a tiny house, there sure are a lot of cool things that you guys keep showing us.
That's the point. Go on down. To call this a living room is to not say everything that it actually is.
We talked about a guest room. You know, this couch, it just folds right back down and it turns into really a full-size bed. But I think the more important thing was you needed a place indoors so you could exercise. And so you got a beautiful walnut coffee table with a little bit of maple inlay. You slide it over and the whole thing just lifts up.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
You got a beautiful walnut coffee table. You slide it over and the whole thing just lifts up.
Oh my gosh.
Wow. Now there's two arms, the sides open up, undo the tab, and now the desk comes down and it locks the wings right in place.
Wow.
You have a beautiful little desk that you can put your laptops, your phones.
Seriously, wow.
And if you can have all these items, why not have a way where you can actually take all of that energy you're expending and transfer it into actual electricity that you can use to power all of those gizmos? So, what I have is a battery pack.
What?
And now, this is called a pedal-a-watt. So you take your bicycle, clamp it down, this part folds back, and then your wheel goes on this little motor there, and it powers all the way into the battery pack. You can power your computer, you can charge your phone.
That is so cool.
This is like, I don't know.
Can you see this being functional and working for you guys?
1,000%.
Yeah, for sure. Before we knew it had all these nifty tricks under it. Like, it's just a beautiful table.
Exactly. Out of sight, out of mind, it becomes a very comfortable living room once again. There's one more thing we need to show you. It's outside.
The tiny house that keeps on going.
That's right.
Thank goodness.
All right, shall we?
Let's go see it.
What Zach built is, I guarantee, the greatest trainer slash desk ever in the world right now. Like, and we have it like in our house.
You guys have so much equipment, and it's equipment that needed to be both secure and accessible.
Zach came up with a pretty good idea.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Wow.
That looks amazing.
Right? Come on up. Check it out. There you go.
This is incredible.
Yeah, it's so perfect. It's like, I was kind of worried about the accessibility of getting the bikes actually down and handling them, but this is so easy. Like, I'm excited.
Show them all the cool tools we got them, too.
Well, since this is your first home together and we built you this workshop, John wanted to stock it up with a bunch of tools that you would need as first-time homeowners.
Having all this already set up for us, it's amazing. This is so cool.
You know, we need to store 4 bikes, but it's also a workshop. So when the bikes come down, the bike stands that come out,
Wow.
We actually got another little trainer machine for you in case one of you guys wants to be outside or if it's just a nice day and you want to come out here and do your training. And one of the neat things that we got going on is we have a really big battery pack, which you can use to charge the electronic parts of your bikes right here at the workshop.
All our bikes are electronic shifting, and so now we don't have to bring the bikes inside to charge the batteries. That's so awesome. You're a genius!
Yeah.
The bike station, it's perfect. What Zach did was above and beyond.
And it's super easy and really great for our lifestyle. I mean, it's perfect.
Because you guys travel so much, because you live and breathe and eat and sleep triathlon, we had to give you a home, somewhere where you could go decompress and didn't feel like you were sleeping in a gym. I hope that we were able to deliver on those asks.
Oh my gosh, this is like exactly what we were looking for. This is perfect. Feeling that not like triathlon all around me, but knowing it's fully functional for triathlon, and that's really cool.
Which leaves only one thing. And that's making it official and welcoming you guys officially to the tiny house community. Congratulations, you guys.
Yeah.
You guys are tiny homeowners. Congratulations.
I'm just so excited just to have a home to come back to. You're just so thankful that both John and Zach helped us. I mean, we asked for a lot in this house and they delivered on all accounts. It's amazing.
We're gonna get out of your guys' hair, okay, you guys? Enjoy the tiny house.
Thanks a lot.
All right, you guys.
Best of luck with everything, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much.
It's been 2 months since Tommy and Katie took on the challenge of shedding their unneeded baggage and crossed the finish line into tiny living. Have they been able to keep up with a full training schedule and the demands of day-to-day living all in a tiny space? We're headed to Santa Cruz to find out.
Having our own permanent place to stay has been a life changer.
And there's Katie down here. She's just getting ready to make breakfast.
Now that we have this tiny house, it just really makes training and everything a lot easier. It just takes that stress away and just really allows us to really prepare and really focus on that 2020 Tokyo goal for the Olympics.
Rainy day, but at least it's pretty out.
We've had pretty bad storms the last few days, and we've gotten all our training done, like 100%. Yeah.
Pop up the table, and Tommy and I can actually both ride in here alongside each other, which makes it that much more enjoyable. To actually be able to charge stuff, it's pretty cool that if we were to decide to go off the grid with the tiny house, that we have a way to charge things.
So Tommy, he's been working on my bike out here, and it's been awesome.
The bike storage and that area, kind of a one-stop shop back there.
I had everything that I needed that I could possibly think of. So we added in the storage underneath the stairs. So I got some cycling stuff, a backpack in there. We actually had way more space up in the bedroom than we thought. We put a nice rug down there so that we can actually hang out.
One of the things that we've added in the kitchen is actually this like beautiful backsplash. Reminds me of the ocean, and I just think it looks gorgeous. I think my favorite thing about spending time in our tiny home together is just because it's just the two of us now.
Are you gonna make me some too?
We can cook whenever we want. We had our wedding gifts for the last 2 years that have still been in boxes, and we finally got to unload them. Our life is just so much easier with the tiny house. We swim, we bike, we run every single day, and we have to sleep, we have to eat properly, and we have to do the same thing every day. It's very repetitive, but having the tiny house all to ourselves, it just makes things so easy. Everything is just incredible.
I'm John Weisbarth, and I travel across the country with my building partner, tiny house expert Zach Giffen, and together we help people build their mini dream homes. On this special edition of Tiny House Nation, Zach and I work with a celebrity power couple that are bigger than life and ready to go tiny. Super Bowl champion and Hall of Famer, primetime Deion Sanders.
My man.
And actress, producer, and extra TV host, Tracy Edmonds.
Thanks, guys. Back to you.
This is a Hall of Fame football player. We need a Hall of Fame house.
This is the top.
Yeah.
We're going here.
Primetime level.
Can we create a tiny sanctuary for Deion and Tracy?
No, dog.
No.
I told you they had some plan for us. Baby, you got me on that one. I ain't saying it.
That still includes the luxury and comfort they'll need to keep the romance alive.
I got a little problem.
You're putting me in an awkward position. Can I throw one more thing at you?
Are they up for the challenge of going from 7,000 square feet to just 600?
Oh, no. It's cluttered.
Every time you say clutter, you look at me, though.
I'm already minimal.
Does he look like he's minimal, John?
You want that fancy bathroom?
Yes, I do.
You beat us. We deliver.
And are Zach and I up for the challenge of facing this Hall of Famer on the gridiron?
I hope you can build a house better than you build a team.
Tiny!
Tiny homes are the next big thing.
This week, we find ourselves in Cedar Hill, Texas, and you will never believe who we're helping to go tiny. Legendary superstar, professional baseball and football player, Deion Sanders, and his girlfriend of 5 years, Tracy Edmonds.
And a big defensive play by Sanders.
I was blessed with a lot of athletic ability, and thank God I was able to play Major League Baseball and professional football. Right now, I'm a youth coach and mentor and NFL Network analyst and so many more things that are attached to that beloved game that I adore.
But Deion's not the only one with multiple responsibilities. This is a true power couple.
I am a co-host on the TV show called Extra. All right, everyone, have a good evening. See you tomorrow. And besides that, I'm a TV and film producer.
The two met 5 years ago at the premiere of one of Tracy's films.
I saw her walk by, like she had on a hula hoop. You know, like shoo, 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 shoo. You know, I told one of my friends who was there with me, oh, it's on. Oh, baby, it's on. You better believe it's on.
Tracy lives in Los Angeles, where her TV show tapes, and Dion lives in Dallas. And this tiny home,
it's gonna be the couple's first home together. In fact, Dion's big picture plan is to eventually dig a fishing lake on this piece of property, 104 acres that he's got out here, and then build other homes around it for his extended family. But the tiny house that he's asked Zach and I to help with, this is the first part of that plan, and it's also gonna be a romantic getaway for him and Tracy when they need to escape from their hectic lives.
I wanna go tiny because I'm a fan of the show. Let's get that straight. I record all the episodes.
He really does.
I've been through pretentiousness of huge and humongous, and I want everybody to know that I've made it, I'm successful. I'm past that. Now it's about needs, not wants. Tiny is for us. That's it.
Yep.
Zach's been here for the past 3 days working with our contractor, Justin from Canyon Creek Homes, to get the home's foundation poured and the framing started.
Dion really likes the idea of windows across the front, and it actually has about 400 square feet of porch space. So that's gonna be fun.
All right, well, I should have known it wasn't gonna be an average tiny house being for Dion.
When I was growing up, Dion Sanders was such a big name, and it's just great to see someone like that doing so much work for kids. I think going tiny and focusing on the things that really matter in life is such a good example for the kids. Go team Dion.
I mean, I like the layout. It's like a nice big living room. You got a good-sized bedroom, kitchen, bathroom. I think it's a great house design. And the fact that there's so much porch space and then a rooftop deck, it's like, I am in. So I guess get at it, huh?
Let's try it.
All right.
While they continue framing up the house, I am on my way to Dallas to meet Dion and Tracy at their current 7,000-square-foot home. Believe it or not, that's already a massive downsize for Dion. His old home was nearly 30,000 square feet. So we're moving in the right direction, but let's be honest, 7,000 square feet, not exactly Spartan. I mean, these guys can't even have a normal conversation without intercoms at this point.
Dion, what do you want to have for dinner tonight?
What'd you say?
So they hope that going tiny will mentally and physically bring them closer together.
Hello.
What's going on, man?
How's it going? Wow.
Going, buddy.
Nice to meet you officially.
Hi. I'm Tracy.
Tracy,
so nice
John.
To finally meet you.
You're Dion Sanders?
Yes.
I used to be a sportscaster, so I know things about Dion Sanders. I know that he's the only player ever to play in a World Series and a Super Bowl. That he's fourth all-time on the interception return list. That he's a football Hall of Famer. So, yeah, I'm freaking out a little bit here.
Thank you for coming to our humble abode.
Yeah, well, humble is one way to put it, I guess.
Well, this is our rental home.
Okay.
It's a little over 7,000 square feet.
Okay. This idea about going tiny, this has been a work in progress.
Right.
Yeah.
Because you make it, you're successful, so you build this monstrosity of a home. Then you start living in it, and over time, you get wisdom. And you say, I don't really need all of that.
Part of what Zach and I do is really determine what is gonna make a tiny house work specifically for you guys. I wanna get a sense of your style.
This does not reflect our style.
Oh, okay.
He likes black and red.
Okay.
And my taste is silvers or grays.
You know when we're at our most peaceful is when we're in a hotel room.
Because there's an intimacy.
Yeah, and that's kind of what we want it to feel like.
We want to have a staycation. I don't like to travel.
Yeah.
I don't like to travel.
I don't know exactly.
Yeah, there's kids. Yeah. My niece, my nephew, my mother lives here.
There's just like people on top of each other.
See what we're saying? Somebody's always here. This is my nephew.
Oh, yeah.
And my niece.
Nice
come
to
meet on. Very nice to meet you.
And this is my sister. As we were just saying, somebody else don't always come.
Dion and I have a long distance relationship. I spend most of my time in LA and he's here in Dallas. So when it's my turn to come to Dallas, I stay, you know, at Dion's house and it's very crowded. So I am really looking forward to this tiny house because it'll give us a chance to just find some us time.
I am interested in how you use this house, so I'd love to see some of the rooms that you do.
We spend time in the bedroom, and we walk to the kitchen, and we go right back to the bedroom. That's it.
Well, let's start in the kitchen, then.
Yeah.
Yes, you can.
Okay,
let's
cool.
Go.
While I'm getting the lay of the land with Dion and Tracy, the crew are busy at the build, adding sheathing, installing a waterproofing membrane on the home's roof, and Zach is checking out some of the stone detailing pieces that will line the home's exterior.
Hey, what's going on with all of the stone?
The entire house is gonna be covered in this stone.
Oh, wow. I'll tell you what, if we're gonna do stone on the siding, I absolutely would say we should do stone on the chimney because the chimney will really stand out, so it should match the exterior. That would be, I think, my first choice.
Right.
All right, why don't you give me a hand here?
Okay, so this is the kitchen.
Nice.
This is Shador, my 14-year-old.
Hi, Shador. I'm John, man.
Shador.
Nice to meet you. So, yeah, talk to me a little bit about what you think you need out of the tiny house to make it work.
Serenity.
Okay.
Peace. Close proximity to the lake.
Okay.
So I could fish and fish.
Fishing is such a big part of my life from early on. Those are vital, peaceful, joyful moments. And I treasure those moments.
Okay, so fishing is a big thing.
Because I never slow down. I'm always going 100 miles an hour with kids, not only my own kids, but at school I coach. I have this youth organization called Truth. I love just molding kids and just encouraging and motivating, just inspiring.
So now's an opportunity to not only give back, but maybe set an example for the youth?
Yes.
It's one of the things that, again, I talk
about. Nice to see you all.
Oh, we got more?
It's always a bunch of kids and people over. You can't even sleep in peace.
And we do get a lot of door knocks. And so, like, right when we're getting into, like, a good nap, then knock, 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 and then you wake up. Yeah. And so, like,
sometimes... you get into some good something else in a knock, knock, all right?
I get it. And this actually makes sense, especially seeing how chaotic the house is. Trizzy has two kids. Dion has five. You add in nieces and nephews. This place is a circus. All Dion and Tracy want is a spot where they can go and be together. And that's what the tiny house is gonna be. I'm starting to understand why tiny. Let's figure out how. I wanna know physically what needs to be in there. Kitchen, obviously there'll be one.
He knows. I don't really cook.
Okay, are you a bathroom person? I mean, usually like kitchens, okay.
Bathroom space is really important.
Okay. I mean, if I could see the bathroom that you're using now.
We gotta put a disclaimer.
It's cluttered.
Whoa.
I know. Why the disclaimers. It was like trying to be a glamorous bathroom, and then you got all of this going on.
Right.
Safe to say this place needs a little tidying up. I mean, I think the bathroom needs a bathroom of its own. I mean, if this isn't your style, what is it that you want?
Good spot for my toiletries.
Yeah.
You know, just enough storage for that. He needs a great shower, right?
I need a shower.
Okay.
That's about it.
Okay, cool. Well, let's see the bedroom.
It's right over
here.
Remember that door unit we were talking about?
Yeah,
I mean... Just delivered it.
Yeah, wow.
We shipped these in from La Cantina.
Look at that.
So this spans the entire front of the tiny home.
These glass doors are awesome. They're gonna open up just like a sliding glass door, only they collapse together like an accordion. So it's gonna completely open up the living room to the outdoors.
Oh man, Dion is gonna be so happy with
this. Oh yeah, for sure.
While Zach geeks out over these high-end goodies, the crew is applying flashing tape to weatherproof the home's many windows, and plumbing is being installed.
We like to watch movies, so that's our thing.
All right, so as far as movie night stuff, that's here?
Yeah, that's in the bed, you know, eating some snacks, cuddling, you know.
Speaking of that.
Snacks. What is this?
This is a gift from God.
Is that hot sauce?
Yes. Hot sauce goes on everything.
This is just for the convenience?
Yes.
The idea of, like, you're in here, snuggled away.
In the old house, we had a full kitchen.
Gotcha.
In the bedroom.
That's why this tiny house is gonna be great, because it's gonna have everything in one little spot, too. But it's gonna be pretty and cute and neat.
Our sanctuary is our bedroom.
Is it?
And so we just wanna lay in bed, watch TV, a lot of times eat in the bed. And we like everything right there for us.
So what I've heard, it's about you guys being able to spend time together. Staycation. The other thing was
the bathroom.
You know, we talked about that, enough storage for toiletries and stuff.
And my fishing stuff.
Okay, and your fishing stuff.
And then an armed guard to keep everybody else from coming in.
You come with me. I got a lot to talk to Zach about. Dion previously lived in a massive 29,000 square foot estate before moving into a modest 7,000 square foot rental property while he and Tracy build the 600 square foot tiny home of their dreams. The couple have different visual styles. Tracy wants a sophisticated modern look while Dion feels comfortable in the clubhouse. So the tiny home will give the best of both worlds with a sleek but masculine aesthetic. The home's exterior will feature stone facing and a large wraparound porch with an overhanging roof, which also enlarges the footprint for the home's rooftop deck. Inside, the living room will be designed for comfort.
the bold fireplace, and plenty of space to entertain or curl up and stay warm together. The downstairs will also have an upscale and modern kitchen, a comfortable bedroom with ample closet space, and a luxurious bathroom. The entire upstairs will serve as an open rooftop deck with gorgeous views of the soon-to-be-added lake and plenty of space to relax and get some sun. On a budget of $130,000 and 14 days to get things done, we should be able to give Dion and Tracy a romantic getaway tiny home with all the bells and whistles they could ask for. It's day four of the build, and with the home's basic structure in place, the crew is installing heating and cooling ducts, the electrical is going in, and in spite of the rain, I'm on my way to check in with Zach to film in on what I've learned from my new BFF primetime Dion Sanders.
How's it going, man? You guys staying dry? Woo!
I mean, kinda. Honestly, you don't even know the half, because...
Oh, dude, does that put us behind at all?
It yeah. Definitely didn't help.
Dude, does that put us behind at all?
This isn't even that bad.
Well, I just got back from hanging out with my buddy Dion. I don't really like to talk about it.
You loved it.
It was so awesome. Are you kidding me? It was pretty sweet. I was just like, keep together.
Yeah.
Like, it was cool. He and Tracy, really nice, really yeah. down to earth.
I can't believe they're into a tiny house.
Yeah, well, they live right now in a rental. It's 7,000 square feet.
You want to know what's the craziest part about that?
What?
That is a serious downsize for them. The house they had before, just sit for a second. Trust me, I don't want you to faint.
Oh, I could use that, actually.
Ready? 29,000 square feet. 29,000 square feet! You could fit 100 tiny houses in there.
So that's not a house.
No.
That's an apartment complex.
Yeah,
it's like a good-sized one.
The thing is, there's a lot of clutter.
That's exactly what we talk about all the time. It's like this idea of tiny and downsizing is just a perspective.
Yes.
You know?
Yes, exactly.
Depending on where you came from.
So let me tell you sort of the key things. Staycation. Retreat. Uh-huh. Some place where he and Tracy can escape for a week or two at a time and have it just be them. And that's what the tiny house is.
Yeah. No, I mean, I love it.
For Dion, fishing is what he's like most passionate about. The bathroom. It's gotta have like a really nice shower for Dion. And she definitely wants storage yeah. and like just an ability for things to be put away. I'm just rattling this off. Can you tell how excited I am?
You're kind of reminding me of a Labrador right now.
Don't throw a frisbee. I might chase after it. I know that's a lot. Are you following what I'm saying?
It's fishing, storage.
Yep.
And then it's like elevated bathroom.
Yeah, and then a movie area. Did I tell you that?
It's called the living room.
Well.
There, I promise, a television.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, the only other thing is that, like, this is a tiny house for Dion freaking Sanders, Hall of Fame football player. We need a Hall of Fame house. Okay, that's all okay. I'm saying.
All right.
All right?
So if this is the top,
yeah.
we're going here.
We're going to prime time level. Got it?
Okay. I got it. Okay. I got it. We'll let you down, John.
Dude, this is going to be so fun. I know you won't, man.
It's day five of the build, and now that the skies have cleared, the crew is making headway on the home's exterior, installing mesh backing and filling it in with concrete, while inside, sheetrock is being installed. While they wrap that up, I'm bringing Dion and Tracy to get a peek at their new tiny retreat.
You guys can see a little
yes,
bit.
Yes, we can.
Of
I'm starting to get excited.
Okay, me too.
You haven't seen anything yet. It's time. Come on over. Come on. I want you guys to be able to see it better.
Wow.
I love
yes.
where they placed it. Because the lake is right there.
The house used the future lake.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to feel like we're on vacation someplace.
Hey, Zach!
I see that familiar face.
Yeah, well, you recognize the suspenders,
yes.
huh?
He's always somewhat dirty and sweaty.
Well, yeah, because he's the one that works hard.
Dion. Oh, man.
There's a nice
thing. Hi.
You guys looking great.
It's a very unique exterior.
Yeah.
Every house should have a rooftop deck.
Thank you, sir.
Like, everyone. I mean, it's just wasted space otherwise.
Yes, it is.
As far as, like, the fishing and stuff, is this just a couple of poles?
No. I usually fish with four poles. Okay. And a couple boxes, you know, full of lures and everything. So I'm going to need somewhere to store all of that.
Yeah. Should we get in here and you guys
want to
see?
I mean,
come on in.
Okay. Yay.
Feel the space a little bit.
Yay.
Unbelievable.
Feel the height on the ceilings here, right?
This does not feel claustrophobic at all.
Now, this is more than great. Any kind of way to in the ground that they could put like a foot massager. I'm just throwing it out since we're here.
A foot massager. Zach.
Yeah.
Make the man happy.
That's easy to do.
Make the man happy.
See that right there?
Oh my God.
That's three surgeries.
Zach, take your shoes off. This is gonna be so gross.
Hey! Happened to you!
It was a bicycle accident.
You have a toe, brother! I'm so excited for you and really disgusted.
Dude! My God! Zach's feet, baby. You know I don't curse.
Yeah.
I use profanity.
Yeah.
But I thought it. Like, when I saw his feet,
there's
a whole lot of words came to my mind. Dang, Zach.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest, this took a much different turn than I thought it was gonna go. Yeah.
All right, well, just so you know, you're standing in the living room. Kitchen is going back against this wall. It's gonna be a full wraparound countertop. Sink, refrigerator, four burner range, dishwasher.
Is there any little area that you can create? You know how they do, like, in the hotels where they have, like, the little area where they have snacks and stuff?
Yeah. Absolutely. Like maybe there's a cool panel or something.
Exactly.
I don't know exactly.
That's all we need.
Okay. Yeah, we can do that.
I am all for making this house as amazing as possible for Dion, but John's a little out of control here.
The biggest part for her is the bathroom.
Yeah. I mean, the bathroom is really the one real tiny house element that you have. I don't want you to get scared, you know?
This is nice, though.
It's gonna be the vanity, big mirror over here, toilets going right here next to the door, and then shower.
This is a nice-sized shower.
It is.
Yeah.
I just want the shower to just hit me all over like a Uzi. You know, just
like
shoot me.
Like a Uzi.
Shoot me all over, baby.
Okay.
Well, I'm glad we had this talk.
Yeah, I guess the biggest struggle for us is gonna be, and I know you guys probably can't do this, is that we're used to two sinks.
Yeah, we can do that.
Really?
Sure.
Ooh, okay.
Yes.
What are you doing? Why are you just trying to give them everything that they want?
It's Deion Sanders.
Okay, the problem with two sinks is plumbing is the hardest thing that we can add at this point.
Okay.
So adding another sink would be kind of a design complication. So I can't promise anything.
Okay. Mm.
Wow.
Look at this view. Oh, my God.
We're up amongst the trees.
And the lake's going to be right there.
I can fish from up here.
I would love to do yoga up here. There's a way that you can create a yoga area for me. Like, that would be amazing.
Do you need anything more than just like a mat?
It's just like shade.
Yeah.
Also, I want like a indoor-outdoor TV, like a big screen.
Ooh.
Since we have some room up here, what about a big projector or something
like
that?
Are you serious? You could do something like that?
Well, yes.
I mean,
we can, right?
And now John is trying to throw in a movie theater. It's like I'm going down an avalanche right now, and John is just looking at the pretty mountains. No help at all.
Just give the man what he wants.
Yes.
It's fine. Just give the man what he wants.
Yes.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
Where's your optimism? This is your opportunity to just, like, kill it.
Well, when you offer to build a tiny runway for his private jet, like, that is where I'm drawing the line.
Okay, see? That's good communication. Scratch that off the list.
I would love something so that there's some kind of food or drink access up here.
If you're gonna be up here watching movies on that big, beautiful screen we're talking about, then we should have some snacks up here.
Let's do that. Come on, Zach.
I don't know if, like, a cooler would be sufficient kind of thing. I mean,
that way we don't have to go downstairs if we need something.
No, no, cooler.
But they're going to have some cool version of a cooler, though.
That's for him to figure out what it looks like.
Zach, we bonded with our feet.
Yeah.
In my mind, I could see just, like, maybe making refreshments somewhat of a priority.
That sounds good.
Okay.
So you guys, you're happy?
We're past happy.
Yeah.
Good. I'm glad you feel like that. It's United.
Mm-hmm.
Something to ask of you, Dion, as well. Can we get an autograph?
Ooh. Just give me right there.
Get you right there.
I don't know where you're going to sign mine. Here on the back.
Could you have absolutely picked a more awkward place to get a signature?
I don't know. I can't believe I did that. I hate that I did that. It was so fanboy, just lame.
Yeah.
Ugh.
I'm actually embarrassed for you.
The only thing we have to do now is get out of here so Zach can get all this stuff we've asked for
done. Let's get Zach busy.
Yeah, let's get him busy.
Zach, I believe in you.
I do too, Zach.
Oh, trust me.
Make it happen, Zach.
He will.
Yay.
But let's get out of here so those hands can do some work.
All right, bye, Zach.
All right.
Come on.
Bye, guys.
While the crew gets back to work painting the home's interior, Zach and our general contractor, Justin, are wasting no time coming up with an ambitious solution for one of Dion and Tracy's new requests.
They had asked for a snack bar in the living room. And at the same time, they had asked for a snack bar on the roof.
Right.
So, correct me if I'm sounding crazy here, but I'm kind of thinking that that can be the exact same snack bar.
Yes, you're sounding a little bit crazy here, Zach.
If we can make this shaft go from the living room to the rooftop deck, I can give them a snack bar in both places. Plus, it can act like a dumbwaiter so they can transport goodies up and down. A tiny house with an elevator. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what I'm calling taking it to the primetime level.
Well, you're known for your projects. So as long as you can get it done without hurting our deadline, I think we can make it happen.
All right.
It's day six of the build, and the crew is mounting decorative stonework to the exterior of the home and adding some organic character by using wooden planks to create an accent wall. While they work on that, Zach is putting his creativity into overdrive, brainstorming a way to create a sunshade for the yoga space that Tracy asked for and give them even more.
My whole concept for the rooftop awning is that it's gonna provide shade for the yoga zone, but it's also gonna be built out of the same material that we use for projection screens. And so part of that awning is gonna be on pivots, and when they wanna turn it into a movie theater, it just rotates down so they can have a full movie theater on the rooftop deck.
While Zach works on the details of his convertible sunshade, I've asked Dion and Tracy to meet me at their big home to go through a little tiny living preseason workout.
My man.
What's up, Dion? How you doing, man?
You doing all right?
Yeah. Tracy here? Come on, we're not wasting any time. We're getting right to business.
What are we doing?
Duffing Adam. We're coming to the bathroom.
Oh, yeah. No.
Yes.
It's cluttered.
Everything is cluttered.
This all made quite an impression on me the first time I came through here. Is this your dream bathroom? Is this the ideal bathroom?
No,
Why not?
Because normally I'm a neat freak.
Okay.
You know, but we just don't have space to put everything.
Well, let's think about the tiny house, because the bathtub, roughly the tiny house bathroom.
No. That tub's the size of the bathroom?
Yeah. So here's what we're gonna do. I want you guys to simulate getting ready for going out in the town.
Okay.
But you gotta do it together in a confined space, and we're gonna see how that feels.
I need to clear my vanity area.
I got you.
Here you go, babe. Cleared your junk. Here you go.
No problem.
Can you get rid of your big speaker?
I got you.
All right. Babe, you can take this big bag of junk too. When I had to clear my area in the bathtub so that I can put makeup on or whatever, I realized how cluttered we were.
Every time you say clutter, you look at me, though.
Yeah, because he's the main clutterer. Take the headphones.
Okay.
Right, we're cleaning up.
Take your green pail. Oops.
I'm looking for this.
Maybe this pencil.
Pencil.
It's not mine.
Okay, well, you know, there was a pencil in my vanity area.
What a grown man need with a pencil?
I don't know. We're not bringing any green pails or pencils to the tiny house. Okay,
no,
babe? No clutter, babe.
Not at all.
Okay. Now you see why we need two spaces, right?
I'm starting to see it.
Yeah, because that was all of Dion's stuff.
I guess everything's relative. I mean, Dion thinks he knows how to go tiny because he went from a 29,000 square foot house to a 7,000 square foot house. But if you take all the stuff that's just in this one room and you put that in a tiny house, I mean, welcome to Tiny Hoarder Nation. All right, well, have a seat.
Okay.
I mean, I get that this is a little silly. What I'm hoping that you guys get from this is a feeling of how a smaller space than you're used to, how that can change what is an everyday activity.
Yeah.
I can tell you that, and that's fine, but when you feel it.
I feel it.
Yeah, well, I know you do.
I'm already minimal.
You are minimal, sir. Does he look like he's minimal, John?
I've also learned that never this look get like in he's the middle minimal? Of these kind of arguments, so I will.
Whenever
that is all his stuff.
This
that
is
speaker,
mine.
The pencil, the green pail.
It's not my pencil.
The point being that it may feel different, and that different a lot of times is scary, but it's not a bad thing. You guys can continue getting ready for your date night, okay?
All right.
Thank you. I appreciate
Thank
it,
you.
Okay?
It's day seven of the build, and while the crew is laying down pergo wood flooring in our primetime tiny home, Zach is busy constructing the metal framework for his snack elevator and cutting through the sheetrock where the elevator door will go. As he works on that, Dion has asked me to meet up with him at a local practice field where he's coaching for his youth organization, Truth, for a quick chat.
So what's up?
I got a little problem.
Okay.
It's our anniversary. And
our anniversary? We just met, buddy. No, I missed you. You trace it?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I want to see if you can hook me up, man. I need the crib done, man. Done. I want to be in the tiny house for our anniversary. Our anniversary is only 2 days before it should be done.
I hope we can pull this off.
You mean you want the home done in 12 days instead of 14?
Yeah.
Okay. You're putting me in an awkward position.
I've already added so much to Zach's plate on this one that, I mean, moving up the build, that's just, it's completely insane. How do I say no to Deion Sanders?
I tell you what,
you don't.
We'll do it. Because there's this smile. We'll make it happen, but we pull this off,
I'm gonna need you to do something for us.
We'll do it, but we pull this off.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need you to do something for us.
How about you let Zach and I and maybe some of the boys come down here and just toss the football around with you, just so we can say, yeah, we're playing catch with the Hall of Famer.
What you mean? Because, you know.
Well, I was
so
just.
I'm not gonna let you beat me deep so you could go and tell all the kids and your friends, hey, I'm Moss Prime Time. Hey, look, it ain't gonna be all that now. So.
Well, what I was really thinking was just like us throwing the ball around, but like flag football. No tackle.
And if you win, we'll give you those two sinks in the bathroom.
Do I think that we can beat Deion Sanders and his coaches in a game of football? No, of course not. If we're losing 2 days of the build already, does it make sense that we even take time to play a football game? I mean, probably not, but listen, this is a chance to play football against an NFL Hall of Famer, and if you think I'm gonna pass that up, you're crazy. This is Deion Sanders. We'll just take a long lunch that day.
Okay.
You down with that?
I'm down with that.
All right, then we will hook you up a house and give Tracy the best
present
possible. I love you, man. I love you, man.
So, yeah, we're gonna have to speed things up by a couple of days at the build site. But more importantly, Deion Sanders just hugged me. I mean, you guys saw that, huh? Yes? Yes. All right, you go, coach.
I gotta
go tell Zach what I just promised us to, okay?
We can make it happen, baby.
We'll make it happen.
Make it happen. My man.
Thanks, Primetime.
My man.
See you, buddy.
My man.
Back at the build, the crew is putting some fun detailing into the bathroom, laying 3D textured tiles on the walls.
Check this out. We'll lay them in different patterns.
Okay. I've never seen anything like that.
It's super fun.
And dark, slate-colored tiles are being added to line the inside of the roomy shower. Zach's convertible sunshade frame is also being welded as the chimney area on the rooftop deck is being prepped to hold the projector unit that will go inside. As that's done, I'm checking in with Zach to see how he's holding up and to break the news of our shortened timeline.
You up there, buddy? Hey, Zach!
What?
What do you mean, what? Oh, it's like a shower.
It's not like I meant to do it on purpose.
You know what? I wouldn't even blame you if you did at this point. So how you doing?
Yeah, we're doing good. We're in a full-time crunch zone.
Where are we on your project?
Let me show you what I want to do for the elevator. Basically, using the space in the chimney, there's going to be a hole cut in the chimney that's going to access our snack bar. Like this, you know? And I got to get it all figured out before I cut into it. But this is an automatic gate opener.
Okay.
This is meant to take a really heavy gate on a horizontal direction.
Yeah.
What I'm gonna be doing is taking it and making it go vertical and then having like a reasonably heavy elevator system that comes up through the cavity that we have for the closet.
Wow.
Like that's what I'm saying. Like we got the motor, we got all the hardware, now we just gotta do it. And then over here, John, this is gonna be a big drawer for the projector, you know, and it'll be able to pull it out and project it over to what is our yoga zone.
Okay.
It'll be a nice shaded awning over here. Part of the awning will just be able to hinge down, and now it's the screen for the projector. So you got
multifunctional, baby. Yeah. Can I throw one more thing at you? This is a good thing. Well, okay.
I don't know if I believe you.
Okay, so when I went and talked to Deion,
he asked if we could move our timeline up a couple of days so he could have the tiny house in time for his anniversary, and
I basically said we could do that.
Did I just hear what I think I did? Because I don't have a tiny time machine. And unless John's gonna provide one, this is going to be a problem.
I sort of threw something at him about getting a chance to play football.
You wanna do a football game?
Well, don't you? And I'm just saying, if you got an hour.
I totally don't have any time to spare. But, you know, you're gonna be playing football with Deion and you need a teammate, you know I'm not gonna let you down.
That's what I'm talking about. All right, good. This is awesome.
Okay, I'll talk with Justin. I'm pretty sure he'll be into it, too.
Okay, I got a whole thing of plays that you're gonna have to look over.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You're pretty serious about this, huh?
Yeah.
It's day 8 of the build, and while I've spent the morning taking Tracy on a quick field trip to pick out furniture for her new home.
We gotta give the man his black couch, I think. It's kind of sexy cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. You wanna test drive it?
Yeah, let's see.
It's very comfortable, actually.
This is a good couch.
Zach has found some extra crew members to come and dig in so we can get this home done a few days early, in time for Dion and Tracy's anniversary. And they're already working to install large closets in the couple's bedroom downstairs. They're also making progress upstairs, cutting an opening for the snack bar elevator and lowering the elevator shaft framework into place in the chimney column. Now, they're getting ready to install steel support beams along the porch to support the roof. And I've arrived back at the build to help lend a hand so we can make sure to get this home done in time for Dion and Tracy's anniversary.
Just be careful, it's really hot.
John, don't try to hold the whole thing, okay?
Oh, fudge. This is hot.
Okay.
Okay, hang on. I can hold this.
Can you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's get on the ladder.
It just got heavier. We're gonna just feed it up to you if you could guide it into place, Zach.
Sure.
Okay.
All right, it's not there yet.
I'm gonna have to square this bottom up and I'm gonna have to pull out.
I got it.
Okay, here. All right, make sure
you got that, Justin?
Hold on.
Okay, John, you got that?
No, I don't. I don't.
John,
look out!
Okay, John, you got that?
No, I don't. I don't.
John, look out!
No, I don't have it.
You okay?
I'm good.
I'm fine.
I didn't realize that you thought I had it up at the top.
I burned myself a little.
Oh, yeah.
As it came down, I was like,
well.
Because it kind of rolled on me and it.
I didn't mean to let go. I thought that you guys had it. I'm sorry.
But it's fine. Okay, quick body inventory here. Arms, legs. Yep, check.
Yeah, head check.
Yeah, all right, good. Carry on, nothing to see here.
Okay, let me get this corner on here.
Okay,
all right, let's get it squared at the bottom.
Yeah, there it is. Hold on. I'll get up there on the ladder now. There it is.
All right. Yeah, the top needs to come towards us, man. That's good.
Okay.
Hey, good news, guys. Only 5 more of these. Perfect.
The rest of the beams went into place with a lot less drama. And then with the roof properly supported, the crew has started building the rooftop deck with beautiful and durable pressure-treated wood planking. And elsewhere. On a quiet field in a small Texas town, an epic battle, one for the ages, is about to take place, where tiny egos and massive stakes are on the line. Hello, sports fans, and welcome to the first ever Tiny House Nation Flag Football Tournament of Champions. John Weisbrot alongside Zach Giffen.
John, our two teams have only had a tiny amount of practice time, and it shows.
Let's take a look at our matchups. First up, Team Primetime, captained by two-time Super Bowl champion and Hall of Famer, Deion Sanders.
Do you think the kids that we coach would really respect us if we allow some tiny house dudes to beat us? Oh, no. No.
Looks like Team Primetime came ready to play, John.
Absolutely, Zach. They look loose and confident. That's exactly what you want to see. Now for our challengers. Team Tiny, co-captained by John Weisbrot, the former sportscaster and all-around tall person, and tiny house expert, pro skier, and suspender enthusiast, Zach the Hammer Giffen.
Yes, I'm wearing my suspenders. This is where I get my power from. This is my socks.
I played 14 years. I don't know anyone that has ever had a problem with their pants being held up during a football game.
Suspenders don't belong on the football field.
Right. Looks like Team Tiny still has some kinks to work out. Let's hope they can pull it together when the game is on the line.
It's a primetime matchup. We've got kickoff coming up right after this.
99 times out of 100, they're going to beat us. Well, maybe today is that day that they don't.
Tiny!
Yeah!
This is the way we play.
Okay.
It's 15 yards first down.
Are we playing the full field?
Yeah.
Okay.
We want to high step and everything. We want to try to bust a hamstring.
Okay. So we're playing sudden death. First touchdown wins. And the stakes, here's what we're playing for.
Okay.
You want that fancy bathroom.
Yes, I do.
You got to earn it. No, you beat us, we deliver.
Okay, if we beat you, which we're going to do, you'll deliver. But if we beat the brakes off you, everybody gets a tiny house!
Wait, no! Oh, gosh!
What have you done?
I don't know. What have I done?
44!
Green 16. Set. Hut.
Oh, it's a trick play, and Giffen with the ball, he makes a lateral pass.
Go get him.
Oh, he's back.
Go get him, Mom.
What a catch by Weisbar.
Go get him, Mom.
That's a first down. It looks like Team Tiny's come to play against the former Defensive Player of the Year.
That was actually a good play.
I just hope they didn't wake a sleeping giant.
We know the play we've worked on, right?
I'm going for you, though.
No, you're not going for me. You're going for Justin deep.
Justin's going deep on the left.
Yes, yes. No, yeah, I'm gonna over here on the right.
Okay.
I'm going to hold.
Hey, you need a piece of wood to write the plays on?
Do you remember?
Don't worry, I brought my power suspenders.
All right, ready? Good. I hope they don't take that long with my house as they take in the huddle.
Set, hut, hut!
What is this thing? I mean, make a play, come on.
I don't know, I'm a skier.
No!
Oh. I hope you can build a house better than you build a team.
Well, that was brutal. Hopefully the Team Tiny can play defense a tiny bit better than they play offense.
Team Primetime is putting on a clinic now, just dismantling Team Tiny's defense.
Ball, 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 ball.
Touchdown, Team Primetime.
I'm not one to brag or boast.
Oh, man.
I would never do that. But in this case, we kick their butts. I just hope they don't take this out on my home.
Yeah.
I'm on the rooftop and fall right through. I'm sorry, guys. I didn't know you guys was back there.
Can we just say that was super, super cool that we just played football with the National Football Hall of Famer? I mean, did we score a touchdown? No.
Yeah.
Did we stop them from scoring a touchdown? No.
So I guess you get both sinks.
Thank you.
One honest question, Dion.
Yes, sir.
Do you guys have an ice bath?
Yeah.
Good game, boys. It's day 9 of the build, and the build site is buzzing with activity in order to ensure this tiny house will be completed in time for Dion and Tracy's anniversary in just 3 days. Luckily, the crew is executing their game plan to perfection, installing the deck railing up along the rooftop and mounting decorative stonework on the chimney stack, while downstairs, the glass-paneled accordion doors are being put into place. While that's happening, I've limped over to the build to catch up with Zach.
Hey, what's up, John?
You tell me, licking your wounds still?
No, but I'm pretty darn sore.
I'm just impressed I can walk.
But you gotta admit, that was pretty fun.
That's what I wanted to hear you say. I mean, did it put you too far behind?
It definitely didn't help, but that's what I'm saying. It's just a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. You don't miss that kind of thing.
Yeah, anyway, how are we doing?
We're moving ahead on the hardest parts of it.
Okay, good.
So you know that I told you we were gonna actually wall in underneath the stairs.
Okay, wow, this is like a full room. We've built tiny houses this big before.
On the inside, I want to do a whole like cabinet area for fishing tackle. And then check this out. We have massive cutting board.
Ah.
It's basically gonna live in the wall like this. Now it hinges down, chains come out, cha-chink, and now Dion's got a nice solid fish cleaning table.
Oh, that's perfect. Yeah, you don't want to do that inside.
And so I want to have a little hose, spray it off, clean it up.
Awesome.
Fold it back up. Done's is done.
Done. I love that.
You might not have your own private lake, but you can make use of your lucky fishing gear even inside your home. Even if you can't make time fishing at the lake, you can still lay back and relax in your old fishing boat. Just put water on the inside, and you've got a clever bathtub boat to soak in. If you've been up the creek a few too many times, don't throw out those old paddles. They can be repurposed and find new life as a handmade bench. This old tackle box can have a new lease on life. Just fill it with soil and plants, and you've got a gorgeous tiered planter. Finding creative uses for retired fishing gear can keep your closets clutter-free and your conversations full in a tiny space.
All right, cool. Well,
we good?
Yeah, we're good.
All right.
A lot of high fives. It must be Dion. Brings that out of it.
While Zach and I tend to our wounds, the crew is busy inside the tiny home, installing custom kitchen cabinets and mounting beautiful quartz countertops. The secret shelf door for the snack elevator is also being painted in red, Dion's favorite color.
Yeah, we see you. Hey, Zach.
Oh, man. man.
How you doing, sir?
Just basking in the glory, aren't you?
I do that really well.
It's all right. You won fair and square. And definitely going to give you your 2 cents. But I'll tell you what, I got to go get material.
Fish?
You and me?
Yeah.
You kill a couple hours while they get the set? Yeah, absolutely.
Of course, while I'm working, John just goes off fishing with Dion.
All right.
Yeah.
We'll see you
we'll
soon.
Right. You.
How come we didn't get to go fishing?
I'm calling my agent.
I'll tell you what, I'll take care of the demo. Anytime you're gonna change up a major design element halfway through the build, you're probably gonna run into issues. By putting 2 sinks in the bathroom, what we have to do now is make 2 drains.
I'm gonna go call the plumber right now.
What is it about fishing that you love?
I think the serenity of it is really not the catching.
It's a time to just not have to think about anything but just some fishing.
Right, right, and I love it.
Tell me about Tracy. How, you know, I know the anniversary's coming up. How long have you guys been together?
We've been together for a long time. She's been one of the best things that has ever happened to me.
Wow. She sounds like a good partner.
She's a good person.
And that's why you want us to finish this off before the anniversary.
Now. I want you to finish it now.
While Dion schools me on the finer points of fishing, Zach is working on a surprise for Dion, and he's asked Tracy to stop by and help out.
Hey!
Hey, Tracy. I'm building him a tackle box.
Oh, that's a great idea.
I just thought it would be really fun for you to come and help me.
I haven't picked up a hammer since, like, wood shop.
So this is the lid. They're going to open like this.
Okay.
So I want to make the inlay on the front.
All right. Dan's favorite thing in the world to do is fish. And so this is gonna cater to that, and Dion's gonna be so excited because I made it.
So,
ooh.
Now.
Like a puzzle, well, it's a little bit like icing a cake.
And now.
It looks good.
It looks like a bass, right?
Yes, that looks really good. I need your help on one more thing. Can I get a piece of wood? I wanna make one more thing that is super, super important for this tiny house.
Hey, if you want to do something for this tiny house, I will find you wood.
So since this tiny house is a little retreat for only Dion and I, I'm working on a little inside joke that I hope he'll appreciate.
It's day 10, and our tiny home build is entering the fourth quarter. But we're going to have to make a hard push to get this house done in time for Dion and Tracy's anniversary. The crew is busy painting the rooftop deck, and underneath, the ceiling of the porch and columns are getting a coat of paint in Dion's favorite colors, red and black. Zach is installing shelves inside the fishing storage cabinet, and the crew is now adding the framework to hold a mini fridge in the couple's snack bar. While that blur of activity happens, I'm meeting up with Zach to make sure that everything is coming together according to plan.
Zach, check it out. This is the projector. He's gonna flip out.
Oh.
I love it.
The elevator's causing the problem right now.
What do you mean?
We're having some technical difficulties with the mechanism.
The elevator doesn't work?
No.
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
The whole function of this is based on an automatic gate opener.
Yeah.
So, right in here, right? That was the problem, is that we had it going. It worked like 10 times in a row. All of a sudden, it's just not. I'm basically walking a tightrope without a net here. I got less than 48 hours to find a new solution to replace the elevator motor. I don't know if there's enough time.
All right, guys.
It's day 11 of the build, and the crew is painting the rooftop deck railing, while inside, they're mounting stone veneer surfaces to the fireplace mantle. While they work on that, Dion has asked for my help finding a surprise gift for Tracy to celebrate their anniversary.
I like that. I really do like that.
That one?
I like that one. I want to get Tracy her gift, but I want to wait till we're up on the rooftop of the deck. Yeah, I'm going to let John hold on to it, so when we get there, boom, we can surprise her with it.
Like I'm going to be like your best man. This is great.
Yeah, you're going to be like my good man.
So I'm in charge of this gift until Dion is ready to surprise Tracy with it. It's a little bit scary, but it's also super cool. And it's definitely going on my resume because I am officially Dion Sanders. I mean, not best man, but at least like pretty good man. That's cool. I can handle it.
You can handle it.
Yes.
All right, let's go wrap this up.
It's going to be a good anniversary.
Back at the build, the crew is working on all the bells and whistles that are going to make this home unforgettable. Zach is installing his convertible sunshade movie screen, and it's being set up to operate from a smartphone app by the specialists at In-Home Genius. While they're here, they're setting up the home's lighting and sound system to also run right from a phone. If that happens, I'm checking in to see if Zach has found a solution to the snack elevator that was stuck on the ground floor.
How are we with the elevator thing?
What if I told you the elevator will work?
Yeah. When?
By tomorrow.
He said with confidence.
Well, the whole automatic gate opener?
Yeah.
That's our problem. So I'm going with old reliable remote-controlled winch.
Okay.
2,500-pound winch.
That's a lot of snacks.
Now this is gonna live and connect onto this beam you see.
Okay.
The winch is gonna wrap around the beam, and then we mount the winch just on top of our whole elevator system. And then it's as simple as just pushing the button, whole thing comes up. And we were talking with the smart home geniuses.
Yeah.
They can actually rig up this system to work from the phone too.
I mean, that's the dream.
So at this point, it's just a matter of getting it all done. Good thing is, I got better help than I've ever had before, so.
Yeah, Justin and the team are really good. Yeah. Or did you mean me?
Yeah, I'm talking about you. It's all you, John.
That's not true, but I will take it. I'm gonna call my mom, she's never gonna believe it. Hey, Mom, you know, he said I helped.
It's day 12 of the build, and we have less than 24 hours before Dion and Tracy's anniversary. So we're hustling to wrap up just a few last-minute items before this incredible home is ready for prime time, and we can hand over the keys to Dion and Tracy. Landscapers have arrived and are planting trees to give a natural contrast to the home's clean, modern exterior, and the couple's upscale kitchen appliances are being delivered and installed. While that happens, ceiling fans are going in, and comfortable patio furniture for the rooftop deck has finally arrived. 12 days ago, Zach and I arrived in Cedar Hill, Texas to help superstar power couple Deion Sanders and Tracy Edmonds build their tiny dream getaway home and downsize from their 7,000 square foot mansion to only 600 square feet of tiny bliss. I saw firsthand how even in a massive home, Deion and Tracy's busy lives and big families made it difficult for them to enjoy relaxing quality time together. They needed a tiny place to get away from big responsibilities and focus on making each other happy. And they had some wild requests for their new tiny staycation retreat. Being the fan that I am, I couldn't say no. The couple wanted their tiny oasis to have space to enjoy their favorite things like watching movies and doing yoga. So Zach found an ingenious way to combine both by transforming a serene rooftop yoga zone with shade into a luxury screening room for two. And since the couple likes their snacks, Zach even included a snack bar elevator so they'll never have to carry their dirty dishes back down to the kitchen as the credits roll. We were making great time, but when Deion asked us to move up our timeline to the couple's anniversary, we kicked things into overdrive. And in return, Zach and I got the once-in-a-lifetime chance to play football against Deion. Zach made some quick decisions on the fly and made fast work of Tracy's request for a double sink. Plus, he got his stalled snack elevator moving just in time. On a budget of $130,000, we managed to fit as much luxury and comfort as possible in this tiny retreat. Now, it's finally time to welcome Deion and Tracy to the tiny home community.
I haven't been this excited in a long time.
This drive is taken, it feels like it's taken forever.
Yeah, wow, I'm doing nice.
Oh, that's beautiful. Oh my God, this is nice.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
Palm trees, baby.
Oh my God, I just noticed that.
Oh my goodness. No visitors, I love the sun.
That was my idea.
I love the sun.
All right, guys.
All right.
Let's check it out. Come on over.
Oh my gosh. God. Look at the red.
I love it.
It's gorgeous.
The stone is beautiful.
It looks like a little oasis.
Come on, man.
You guys feel like seeing the inside?
Yes.
Get in there. Okay. Get in there. I'll let you guys check it out. Zach and we'll come in a moment.
Is this the door?
Yep.
I know you like all these windows,
right? Oh, you know I do.
Thank you. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh, this is so pretty. Look at the fireplace.
They even got our pictures, baby. Baby, you picked the furniture?
Yes, I did.
I love all of this, baby.
Oh, good. Yes, we got hardwood floors.
You love that.
That kind of pulls in nature a little bit,
baby,
right?
The kitchen is awesome, though.
This feels like a nice big
this
kitchen.
This is a full kitchen.
Yeah. You want to see the bedroom
first?
Yeah,
I want to see the room first. No, I like this.
Oh.
Let's see your closet.
Let's see the closet.
Baby, that's a huge closet.
It is.
For a tiny house, that is huge.
And they've got all the shelves and everything?
Yeah, let's see your bathroom.
Oh my gosh.
This is huge.
Oh my gosh. This is so gorgeous. They got the two sinks in here. Oh, you have to see the shower. You're gonna be really happy with the shower.
They hit me like a Uzi.
Yeah.
Oh, they hit me like a Uzi.
And they've got the ceiling faucet things too. They could not do anything more with this bathroom.
Maybe
this bathroom
they killed is, it.
They did.
Hello, hello.
You guys, I have to hug you guys again. You guys outdid yourself.
I'm not surprised easily, but this is a whole nother level.
It's more than I could have ever imagined.
I love it.
You know, that contemporary modern feel on the outside, mm-hmm. we really wanted to transition that in here. And that's a clean lines, muted tones.
And you guys did such an amazing, beautiful, awesome job, like taking both of our tastes and incorporating it and blending it. It's incredible.
It's really classy.
I want to talk about the bathroom. I mean, we played a football game about this thing.
I'll sit here while you talk.
Yeah, exactly. It was not that long ago. We were right in here, and you two wanted an octopus arm, Uzi shooting shower. Yeah. Zach pulled it off. I was like, Zach, that's a tall order. I mean, how many different shower heads are in there? Like
right.
Six or seven.
Unbelievable.
Honestly, the Uzi shower was actually easier to pull off than the two sinks.
I just need to praise all three of you guys for those two sinks. And it's gorgeous. The bathroom is off the chain. They got the two sinks in there. Thank you.
They gave me the Uzi shower that hits me all up over while I'm shaking.
Let's get back to what you guys really asked for and what you guys said you like to do. Watching movies, eating some snacks.
My man.
Your man, right here.
Dedicated snack zone. Behind door number one.
No.
Very own snack zone.
No.
With plenty of hot sauce.
Okay, that's better than a hotel room. Oh, I love this.
This is awesome, man.
You guys have made me so happy. This is awesome.
I wish that was it.
Yeah.
No, don't. No, man.
What?
That goes all the way up.
No!
No!
You come
out
to the deck? No.
All the way up to the deck.
My God.
And I control it with my phone.
That is so brilliant.
No, man.
So awesome.
Do you want to go see where it takes
us? Oh, yes, I do.
Well, let's go.
Follow us.
Baby! This is awesome. I'm floored, and I'm not easily wowed whatsoever. Not at all. That right there, that's off the chain.
It is.
So before we go up there, come this way.
Watch your step here.
Be careful, baby.
Okay.
And that lake is there. It's gonna be all about fishing. And so that's what this is. Just undo the latches. Now the whole thing just
oh my God.
Drops down. Oh.
You got to be kidding me,
it's
man.
It's cutting board. You can clean your fish. And when you're done, here's a hose.
No.
Straight off.
No.
This is awesome.
And it wouldn't be a tiny house if we didn't utilize understair storage.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Oh,
I knew I'd strike a nerve. Yes.
This is huge. Wow.
Recognize all your gear in here?
Yes, I do. What is this?
Bring it out here. Let's put it on the table.
Something Zach and I made for you.
With your hands?
Yes.
We did this nice inlay of the bass in the top. If you open it up, now you got a little transportable one.
Oh.
You can take on the boat with you.
All right. Baby, you did that.
A little bit of help.
I'm proud of you, girl.
Thank you. Thank you.
Do you guys finally want to see the top?
Okay, let's go.
You guys ready?
Yep.
All right, come on.
All right. Look at Tracy. She's like, no, we have to go up here.
Oh, my God.
Look at Tracy. She's like, no, we have to go up here.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. You've got to be kidding me.
Wow.
Now, this is a deck.
Yes. This is awesome, you guys.
This
it's
is
so
a
pretty up
deck.
Here.
You can see some yoga out here.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that little canopy in case we need shade, in case it's too hot.
At the height of the day, this is perfect shade.
God, I could fish from right here.
You see, I can bring a book out here, take naps out here. You guys, I'm so ready to start tiny house living.
Oh, that's great. That is so great.
Is that the spot where the little snack thing comes up?
I'm so glad you asked. Shall we check it out?
Yep.
Undo the latch, open it up, here it is.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
Good Lord.
It's just brilliant.
The stuff they did is the kind of stuff you call people and tell people, and they don't believe. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're like, dude, I got an elevator for my food.
And there's plenty of hot sauce.
Yes. Thank you for all the hot sauce, too, by the way.
Yeah, oh, yeah, listen, there was no way that thing wasn't going to be stocked with hot sauce.
Yes. I cannot
get over
that. You
guys thought of everything up here.
This is the most tiny house chimney that's ever been built in the entire world. We got an elevator in there, and we also have storage on this side for all of your electronics, including
you
a projector.
Be kidding me, man.
A projector?
A projector.
Stop.
Canted on the perfect angle.
Stop.
To be showing right towards your projector screen.
Stop.
What projector screen?
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny that you asked that. I guess I'll just have to.
No, dog.
No! No.
No.
So, did somebody order a movie theater?
Okay, that is so clever. I did not see that coming. That is so clever. Oh, my gosh.
I told you they had some. This is why I love this show, man. I told you they had some playing for us, baby. Got me on that one. I ain't saying. A canopy that flips over into a movie screen.
Yeah.
Like that right there. That's off the chain.
It is.
I don't know what to say. And I knew you had one up your sleeve, and I couldn't figure it out.
No, I did not see that coming at all.
As far as a construction project goes, there was a lot of requests. John had.
Whoa. A lot of requests that I relayed.
Good point. That's a good point.
Let's keep in mind who was
doing
the requesting.
You guys got every request in, though. Like, I mean, I can't think of anything that we're missing.
There was a lot of pressure. I mean, it's not every day that we get to build for a Dion and a Tracy, you know? And so this was a big deal for us. It makes us really happy, for sure.
This is everything that we need as a couple. Thank you.
There is one more little thing we gotta take care of. Right?
Almost,
that's right.
Almost forgot.
You know, yeah.
It is our 5-year anniversary, and I want to blow her mind. I want to set it off. I want to be that. Oh man. I wanted to make her call all her girlfriends and tell all her girlfriends what I did. Thought I forgot. It's our anniversary. Thought I forgot.
I was not expecting this. Let's see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's when you know you did that thing, right?
You just
stopped moving. Yeah.
Babe, you did right.
Sorry.
Give me, and I need a hug too.
Happy
5th anniversary. So your surprise is coming.
What you talking about, girl? What she
Before we run off for that surprise.
What she talking about?
When we first thought about Deion Sanders going tiny, there was a lot of head scratching. Why does Deion even want to do that? And then getting to talk to you guys and understanding that this was about the two of you guys really having a place to connect, to get away from the chaos, and asked for a lot. I mean, there were yoga zones, there was big screen stuff.
And it's not that we didn't want to do everything possible, it's just we didn't want to let you down.
I'm so grateful. Thank you guys so much. You made us so happy.
Well, it was absolutely our pleasure. The last thing to do is to officially welcome you guys to the tiny house community. Welcome, you guys. Welcome.
Yay. This is our key.
Yes.
Yes.
Your key to tiny living.
Our tiny house. How they were able to, like, blend everything together and make both of us so happy. Like, I mean, thank you. Thank you guys so much. But, you know, it is our anniversary.
It's anniversary
night,
time. Absolutely.
No. No. I mean, like, they're sick of us, Deion.
All right, you guys.
Thank you, guys. I really feel like we have the best tiny house ever, but I know everybody probably feels the same way, but
yeah,
I
but
really
they
do.
They just saying that. We dead serious right now.
Yeah. Thank you. Happy anniversary, my love. To us.
To us. We love everything about the tiny house. It provokes peace, joy, serenity, love, appreciation, all that.
And you know what else too is that this is the first time that we've had a chance to create a spot together, and it feels really special.
Is this peace, baby?
Baby, this is the life. Thank you.
This peace.
Mm-hmm.
I just want you peaceful.
Yes.
It's been 2 months since Dion and Tracy celebrated their anniversary by taking the keys to their tiny romantic staycation retreat. How have they adjusted to a break in their whirling storm of work, responsibility, and family? We're headed to Texas to find out.
Yes, that breeze feels so nice. Going tiny has brought us even closer, right, babe?
Yeah, the living space is definitely comfortable. Man.
So, yeah, the bathroom is awesome. So I have my space to get myself ready. He doesn't have to invade my space because he's got his own space.
We got a wonderful shower, hits you from all angles. All angles, like a car wash.
It's pretty awesome.
And I love the deck.
I've totally used my yoga zone, and I love it, like, because I'm outside, I have a nice view, I'm in nature. The only downfall is when it rains. And so when it rains, you know, then you get the wet deck and stuff. But it hasn't been raining that much, so we're good. And we have our snack stations. I don't have to go up and down the stairs. It's easier than carrying things,
right?
Oh,
it's definitely easier. Yeah. That's definitely easier.
Okay.
You hungry?
Snack.
All right. I'm gonna get popcorn.
And then at least, probably about half a mile from anybody else.
And we love that. That's the best part.
Yeah. The tiny house is not for family. The tiny house is just for us.
Well, I happen to think this was like the best anniversary gift ever, because this is the gift that keeps on giving.
Foot massages will always do the trick.
I would recommend tiny houses, you know, to everybody.
Once upon a time, we thought we needed more in an extravagance of life, and really, you don't.
Nobody's going to top this one.
No, I think this has got to be the best tiny house ever. I'm convinced.
So we're happy.
It's wonderful.